White here. Back to pass. Down the sidelines. The pass is intercepted at the 20-yard line. Run out over the 30, the 40, the 50. Down the sidelines inside the 50, to the 30, to the 20, to the 15, to the 10, to the 5, and into the end zone for the Indy touchdown. That's Judah Price.
Also, with the 35-point advantage, the play clock will run continuously through the fourth quarter.
They mentioned running the play
clock. The celebration has begun. What a night and what a season it has been for the Independence Patriots as they become the first Class AA unbeaten since Fairmont Senior in 2018.
Because two men enter!
One man leaves, two men enter! One man leaves, two men enter! One man leaves, two men enter! One man leaves!
He's a warrior, man. He's battling. He's banged up. He's taking shots. They're a physical team. You're going to have to gut it out. You guys can see he's free to talk amongst the best players in the state. Big stages. He does it every time. He makes incredible catches, incredible plays, strips a guy on the kickoff. Yeah, God does it all.
East West, keep the offense hot. I'll toss you with them choppers. West side, how we rock it, pull up on you, get the poppin'. Hey, them boy don't want no smoke. Them boy don't want no smoke. East West, keep the offense hot. I'll toss you with them choppers. West side, how we rock it, pull up on you, get the poppin'. Hey, them boy don't want no smoke.
Man, them boy don't want no smoke.
Them boy don't want no smoke.
Independence and Fairmont Senior don't need to schedule one another for a regular season game because in the last four seasons, the two teams have met in the playoffs each time. Last year, the Patriots manhandled the Polar Bears in the quarterfinals and eventually won the AA championship. Before that, Fairmont had beaten Independence in the championship and the quarterfinals. Tonight, from East West Stadium in Fairmont, it's the semifinals. The number 2 Fairmont Senior Polar Bears will battle the number 14 Independence Patriots. And now, let's meet tonight's players.
Brody Whitehair, number 4, senior.
Dylan Hours, number 5, senior.
Imani Johnson, 8, junior.
Chris Wilson, 21, junior.
Max Rosero, number 40, junior.
Cannon Dinger, 10, junior.
Javon Jones, number 11, junior.
Logan Canfield, number 2, junior.
Gavin Michael, number 14, senior.
Riley Green, number 72, senior.
Joseph Richmond, number 61, senior.
Caleb Arbogast, 50, junior.
Trevor Bigelow, number 55, junior.
Ezra Lister, number 68, I'm a junior.
Caleb Angelon, number 57, senior.
Love Cool Kalkini, 65, junior.
Luke Amazino, number 33, senior.
Karen Boda, number 3, sophomore.
Tavion Thorne, number 81, senior class.
Jordan Wagner, number 1, junior.
On this Independence team,
that's the contest between let us honor and respect our country by standing as
the Polar Bear Band.
When you look back at it, it's really all motivation.
Coach John Lilly.
And, you know, we lost 15 three-year starters off the team before, you know, the state championship team. And those guys have been in back-to-back state championships. We had kind of started over a little bit. And it took a while for our kids to learn how to play high-caliber ball. And then on top of it, you know, we played three playoff teams and they happened to get us. But as I told everybody at the beginning of the year, we needed to be better at the end of the year than we are at the beginning of the year. And fortunately for us, our team just kept getting better and doing things a lot better than what they were doing.
You have Trey Bowers as a receiver, not a quarterback anymore. What was the reason for that change, and what does that add to your team there?
Well, we felt like, you know, we had both our playmakers in the backfield, and everybody knew where they were at. So when we moved Trey out, it kind of opened up our offense a little bit and let us be a little bit more open, you know, and more balanced in the pass and the run game. So that was pretty much the main thing with that. And we felt confident with the kid that we had of a quarterback, Silas Nelson. So, you know, we just felt like that was the move that was going to make us better. And fortunately, like I said, we've gotten better every game.
Tell me about this Fairmont team.
Well, I think they're different than the previous three teams that we played. They seem to be a little bit more wide open as far as throwing. You know, the previous three times, you know, it don't hurt that you're probably going against, you know, two NFL guys in the future on that line and maybe two or three other ones, you know. So, you know, they don't have those guys. Of course, they got Troy, and he's pretty good. But, you know, they're not quite at that level yet. And they just seem to be more wide open. They seem to be having fun. We try to do the same thing. We try to have fun. And it should be a fun game.
That's head coach John Lilly. He brings his team into this game tonight with an 8-3 overall record. J.L. Abbott is with me. J.L., how about a scouting report on these Patriots?
All right, Jeff, tonight from Independence, offensively, we're going to see him mainly or all in the gun. It would be a gun wing. Like to run power and counter, some jet motion from time to time. Defensively, we're going to see a 3-4 cover 3. They're not afraid to bring the linebackers. This game is going to be won in the trenches. And, hey, fasten your seatbelts.
I did have a chance to check in with a key Polar Bear player, Dylan Hours, before the game to get his idea on not just this game tonight, but how his career has been winding down.
When you think back to the game last year and a game that really was not much of a contest between you guys and this team, what does that bring to this game tonight?
Well, when you look back at it, it's really all the motivation you need. You know, you've been had a year to get back to this moment. We've been waiting for it, especially in the playoff matchup. So, you know, I'm looking forward to it. Look forward to a big matchup with my teammates. I know we all want the win back, especially after rough last year. You know, there were some times in the game where I looked at it like, yeah, I'm definitely going to, you know, look forward to next year and seeing these kids again. So I'd say this is the time for us to overcome that and take out the win.
What's going to be the secret tonight to having success?
Well, I'd say the secret was all week. You know, I've studied really hard. I know my teammates have as well. But I think if we can attack their defense and the way we play as an offense, and I think if we can shut them down on our defense, we can just play our game.
How about having enough time to throw and make plays?
Oh yeah, that for sure helps, but I've had it really, the past weeks after we played, I've had great protection in the pocket. I'm still confident throwing the ball with my line, so that definitely helps in terms of the passing game, but like I said, my line stepped up, so they'll have a big role in this game as well.
No matter what happens tonight, this is your last game here this season. What's that mean?
It means a lot. You know, you like to defend your home turf pretty well, and I'd like to say we've done that really good all year. I think we only have one loss here, so, it's a very important game to us. I know it is to our seniors, being their last game, so, you know, I'm going to play my hardest for them and play my hardest for the team, same as the island.
That's not Polar Bear running back Dylan Hours, but quarterback Brody Whitehair on his thoughts on this game tonight, which is just about getting ready to start. It'll be Independence kicking off to the Polar Bears from right to left. Independence white uniforms, red numbers, and the Polar Bears in the all blue.
Back deep for Fairmont Senior.
Doing the kicking for the Patriots will be Micah Cuthbert. And he'll tee the ball up in the center of the field, kicking from right to left and back deep for the Polar Bears. On the far side, it's Hours, and on the near side, it's Canfield. A lot of times they don't kick the ball that deep. We'll see how Cutworth will approach the ball here. And there's a little short end-over-end kick, and it's going to be taken at the 44-yard line and carried up close to the 40. Taken at the 34, up to the 40.
You know,
Polar Bears will go first and 10 from there.
Yep, Jeff, our special team's been playing real well all year, and great field position to start the game. I mean, I would definitely take that. Can't have a run back. We'll take it there at the 40, the 44.
So the football set down, far hash marks, 39, first and 10 Polar Bears. Fly to the near side, Gavin Michael, who has returned after missing the first two playoff games with an ankle injury, and his absence has been felt by the Polar Bears. He's a wide out to the right side. Quarterback Whitehair has Johnson going in motion out of the backfield, and Brody back to pass, swings it over the middle, and the pass is caught and taken out over the 45, and then the ball pops loose, and Independence has it.
Yeah. You know, on a cold night like this, and the ball security is going to be the most important.
Cannon Dinger caught the pass, but then couldn't hang on to it. And the ball is recovered by Independence at the Fairmont 41. So, bad start for the Polar Bears tonight.
It's a stolen possession, Jeff.
And Independence has the ball. Not only do they get it, but they get it in Polar Bear territory with 11:45 to go in the first quarter. Trey Bowers goes in motion, and there's a flag at the line of scrimmage.
You know, coming into the game, knowing number one is going to be his number one target, look for Trey Bowers to get a lot of touches tonight.
Bowers started the season as their quarterback. He quarterbacked the team last year.
Dead ball, false start. Offense number 72, 5-yard penalty, first down.
He was the quarterback in the game that the Polar Bears lost down there in Cold City, 42-7. But this year, after they started the season poorly, they moved him to a wideout position and brought in Silas Nelson. He is the quarterback now on a first down and 15, the ball at the Fairmont 46. And there's a quarterback run right up the middle. He runs into Dylan Hours, and he's going down at the 45.
You know, normally when they run the quarterback, they'll run it with a quarterback counter. Here, they just ran quarterback ISO. Dylan did a nice job stepping up in the hole.
They get 2 yards. It'll be second down and about 13, 14 yards to go for the first down. The ball mark at the Fairmont 45-yard line. 11:16, turning clock first quarter. Independence after a Fairmont fumble has the football early in this game. Bowers goes in motion out of the backfield, handoff to Linksweiler. Linksweiler is hit, and he's going down for a loss on the play. Tyler Linksweiler, the ball carrier, but he'll lose a yard.
Yeah, great.
Bigelow's got him third and 15.
Yes, sir. Great play by our defensive lineman, Trevor Bigelow, number 55. Just came straight down the line and made a play.
So now third down 15, the ball at the Fairmont 46. Now they love to throw the ball or get it into the hands of Trey Bowers. And their quarterback, Silas Nelson, has the capability of getting the ball to him. Bowers is in the slot to the left now on this third and 15. Taking lots of time at the line of scrimmage now. Linksweiler beside the quarterback, Nelson back to pass. He's locking one downfield in double coverage, and the pass is incomplete. Right here, come over from his safety spot to help out Jelani Johnson, and Christian Linksweiler was the intended receiver, but it's overthrown, fourth and 15.
You know, it was a great job by our free safety getting over the top. Good pressure by our defensive line getting in the quarterback's face. Brings up a well-needed fourth down, and I think they have to kick it to ours now, Jeff.
So Nelson, the quarterback, is also the punter. He stands at his 42-yard line. He'll punt it from right to left. High snap, brings it down, and punts it away down the center of the field, but it's going to bounce. And it takes an Independence roll inside the 20 down to about the 19. But if you had told me the Polar Bears would get the ball back at the 19 with no damage done, I'd have said, take it.
Perfect.
And that's what Fairmont has done now. They get it back after the turnover in their own territory at the 19 with the clock showing 9:57 to go in the first quarter.
Yeah, ball security is going to be number one priority tonight, Jeff, especially with these temperatures so low. I mean, that ball's going to feel like you're carrying an ice cube. You just got to squeeze high tight.
Empty backfield for Whitehair now. On a first down and 10, Dylan Hours goes in motion from right to left. Whitehair gets the snap, pumps once, now runs to the far side. He gets out over the 20, up to the 25, slides down just over the 25-yard line. They'll set it back now down at the 25. And it'll be a gain of 6, second down and 4.
Hey, gain 6 yards on first down. You take it nowhere away, you can get it.
Cannon Dinger comes out as a wideout to the right side. Polar Bears have two receivers to the left. And in the backfield, Hours is behind the quarterback, Whitehair. And Hours gets the ball off the left side. Dylan runs through the center of the line and gets a couple, and that'll be about it, up to about the 28-yard line.
Yeah, it's going to be tough sledding tonight. Especially the way they're walking their backers up that close to the line of scrimmage. They're definitely playing run first.
A 3-yard gain, so it's third and a yard to go for the Polar Bears. Hours lines up behind Whitehair on this third and short play. Polar Bears try to draw them off sides. That doesn't work. So Whitehair comes back now. Calling the signals, looking for a yard on the third down play. And he gives it to Dylan White, to Dylan Hours off the left side, and he's got the first down and more out over the 30, the 35, and up to the 37-yard line. It's a Polar Bear first down.
Yeah, nice job by the left side of our line, getting a push, open a hole, and Dylan made the first guy miss.
9-yard gain for Hours, and the first down of the game, and it belongs to the Polar Bears at the 37 in Fairmont territory. 8:25 turning clock. This game just underway from East West Stadium. No score. Polar Bears with their second possession. Whitehair is back to pass now. Getting some pressure. Runs to the near side of the field. Off balance throws. Intending it toward Jones. Can't hang on to it at the 50-yard line. Incomplete.
Number 7,
Rashawn
Sims with the
cover. Yeah, Brody got a little pressure up in the middle, and he bailed to his right. It was a good pass. Should have been caught.
Second down and 10 yards to go now. Fairmont moves from left to right. They're on the far hash marks, closer to the Polar Bear bench. Two wideouts to the near side, Michael and Dinger. And there's Hours keeping the football, and he takes it off the left side up to the 40, and that's where D. Heights makes the stop. Their linebacker will say his name a lot tonight.
Yeah, he's a good player. You know, Jeff, as you can tell, they're playing their inside linebackers up nice and tight. Which we've been able to check out that to a pass, but it'll open up here soon.
Third down and 7. They'll definitely expect a pass here. And Whitehair is back to throw. Swings it over to Johnson. Catches it at the 40, up to the 45, and then dives out of bounds. Close, but just short of the marker on the far side of the field by about 1 yard. He'll get 6, and he needed 7.
Yeah, it was a, swing pass all the way. Just wish he could have got another yard.
And the Polar Bears have Dylan Hours. It had running back and Whitehair, and now Hours comes up under center as though he's going to run the quarterback sneak, and the Patriots jump offsides.
Yeah, Polar Bear freeze. It's the cheapest 5 yards you can get.
That 5-yard penalty gives the Polar Bears a first down now.
Dead ball, encroachment. Defense number 66, 5-yard penalty
gives
the first down.
Micah Brown was the player, 6'3", 310-pound senior who
after
jumped.
The penalty, Fairmont Senior will be first and 10.
And the Polar Bears get 49. First down number 2. And the ball is in Independence territory for the first time tonight at the 49. No score in this game. Whitehair in the pistol. There's the end around coming to Canfield. Canfield running inside the 45, nice. Down to the 40, and close to the 37-yard line.
Very nice, Jeff.
It's another Polar Bear first down.
Yeah, we just ran counter, pulled the backside guard and tackle.
12 yards on the game.
Result of the play will be a Polar Bear first down.
So the Polar Bears have it. at the Independence 37, first down and 10. Michael wide to the near side. Three receivers left, give to Hours, breaks it to the outside. He's at the 35, he's at the 30, he's at the 25, and he goes down inside the 20. The ball comes loose. Let's see what the officials say. And they say the ball is down, and it's Fairmont's football.
Yeah. Ground can't cause a fumble.
Dillon gets an 18-yard gain.
Nice push by our offensive line. Good blocking downfield, and Dillon got another first down.
Football marked inside the 20 at the 19 as the Polar Bears go from left to right now. White here in the pistol formation, and he's back to pass. Getting pressure, runs to the near side of the field, fires it downfield. A diving catch by Dinger. He's got it inside the five.
Jeff has been doing that all year. He's got pressure up the middle. Brody bailed to his right, being a right-handed quarterback. Is more, he's got more control going to his right, and he hit our best guy, number 10, Dinger.
Dinger makes those diving catches routinely for the Polar Bears, and it's another Fairmont first down, and it's first and goal now from the 3-yard line. Hours comes up now at the quarterback spot under center, takes the handoff, and he runs it right up the middle, and he drives to the goal line. He's into the end zone. It's a Polar Bear touchdown. Dillon Hours takes it in from 3 yards out, scores his 11th rushing TD of the season, and Fairmont leads it 6-0.
You know, you can't call it a tush push because it's illegal in high school, but we've been doing it here all year. Dillon did a nice job of finding the open gap and sticking his nose in it.
Extra point attempt coming for Cam Peschel from left to right. It is up and it is good. Peschel now 57 of 61 this season. Timeout on the field, 6:06 to go. It's Fairmont 7, Independence nothing on Fun 93.1.
Hi, my name is Zach Frazier and I'm from Fairmont, West Virginia. And when I'm back at home in Fairmont, you'll find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that Golden Boot Pride at Parmar. There are literally hundreds of Parmar stores in West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, and even more on the way. Download the Parmar app to save even more. And whether it's food, gas, groceries, or whatever, we have you covered at Parmar. West Virginia proud and ready to serve you.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
Penn State 3, Michigan State 0, Final, Missouri 48, Arkansas 14, Final, Iowa 13, Nebraska 10. Kick it off for Fairmont Senior, number 10, Cam Dinger. Back for Independence, number 1, Trey Bauer.
Yeah.
Peschel's kickoff goes into the end zone, and it'll be a touchback. So Independence gets the football at the 20-yard line. First down and 10, much different from the first possession, which started in Fairmont territory.
You know, as a defensive coordinator, you love that. You love touchbacks, getting them, you know, making the offense start on the 20 and go 80 to go. We'll see if the Polar Bears using that momentum off that touchdown they just scored moments ago.
Quarterback Silas Nelson. In motion comes Hypes, and the handoff goes to the near side of Lynx. Waller, and he is nailed by Canfield behind the line of scrimmage.
Yeah. Beautiful by Brody Whitehair.
Oh, that's Whitehair. Sorry about that.
Oh, yeah, Brody read it dead bang. He read it. He read the guy coming down, trying to hook block, and came up with some, and made a nice play.
Two-yard loss for Linksweiler.
That might be the first person Brody's actually hit all year.
And I called him Canfield. It's second down and 12 now. And the quarterback, Nelson, back to pass. He is lofting one downfield, and the pass is batted down, and we have a flag thrown on the play. Ooh.
Not too sure about that one.
We have our unofficial review now.
Yeah, I don't know what that's, Okay. It looked like a good play.
So there is no review for a play like that. And it is a first down by penalty, 15 yards from the line of scrimmage.
They can review it next week, Jeff.
So that'll be a first down for the Patriots. And sad thing about that is the Bulldogs had that pretty well defended anyway. 15-yard penalty against Fairmont and a first down for the Patriots at the 33.
I thought that was a good play by Tay.
Davion Thornton was the player guilty of the flag. And this is the quarterback, Silas Nelson, carrying the ball off the right side, grabbed by the shoulders and thrown down at about the 37-yard line. He'll get about 5 yards on the play.
14, Gavin Michael. Just another quarterback ISO.
Gavin Michael back in action defensively, and he's one of the Polar Bears' best tacklers. Call that a gain of 4, actually. Make it 2nd down and 6 for the Patriots, trailing the Polar Bears 7-0. And here is Linksweiler again. He takes the ball off the left side, and he takes it over the 40 to the 41, but he runs into resistance there, and Michael was one of the ones to provide it.
Yeah. It was a good push by their offensive line, and you know, he gained a couple yards, getting closer, making a manageable 3rd down.
Be 3rd down for Independence.
It'll be 3rd down. And they've got to get a long one to go. So about a 5-yard gain for Linksweiler on that last carry. He's now in positive yards rushing. 3rd and a long 1 from the 42-yard line. Quarterback Nelson, play action, back to throw. Throws it downfield, overshoots his defender, his receiver, and it's incomplete. And it's 4th down. And a long one to go for the Patriots.
Yeah, we got good pressure up the middle. I believe it was from Arbogast, number 50.
Coverage by number 10, Cannon Dinger. 4th down.
Dinger was a step behind, but the ball was overthrown.
So the quarterback is also the punter, and he stands back in punt formation. A little bit of a surprise on that 4th and short that they would go to the air, but the Polar Bears now could be getting the football back. Line of scrimmage is the 41-yard line. Good snap. Takes lots of time. Gets the punt away. High floating punt, and Dylan Hours gets away from it, and now it takes a Polar Bear roll, and it's not down until it reaches the 37-yard line. Polar Bears have it in pretty good field position.
Yeah, that always makes me nervous because that ball's not round, right? So we don't know how it's going to bounce. So Dylan's telling them to get back, and we still had two guys in the vicinity. That as a coach, that drives you nuts.
32-yard punt. Fairmont with the football. 3:56 to go first quarter. 7-0. The Polar Bears in the lead. 3 wideouts to the left side now. White here. Has Hours behind him, and he gives Dylan the ball. He avoids a tackle at the line of scrimmage, then takes it wide to the right, takes it up to the 44-yard line, close to the 45, and he'll have a good gain on first down for the Polar Bears.
Yeah, I'd sure like to say, you know, the blocking was there, but Dylan got all that on his own.
Dalton Williams in on the stop. That's a 7-yard gain for Dylan Hours, who is up to 42 yards rushing tonight. On the season, Dylan is just over 700 rushing yards. It'll be 2nd down and 3 from the Fairmont 44. And Whitehair's back to pass, getting pressure. Runs out of the pocket to the near side and then gets back to about the line of scrimmage. He tries to stick that ball out as he's going towards the sideline. And they're going to mark him down for no gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down and 3 from the 44. 3rd down and 3, rather, from the 44.
Yeah, they brought the middle linebacker, and he wasn't accounted for coming up A-gap.
They're down 3 yards to go. And time at the line of scrimmage. Independence wants a timeout. 3:13 left, first quarter from East West Stadium in Fairmont. It's the Fairmont Polar Bears 7, the Independence Patriots nothing on Fun 93.1.
I'm Keith Powell, and going on right now is my Keith Says Yes Fest. I'm saying yes to lowering your payments, yes to your trade-in, regardless of condition, miles, even if you're still making payments. My Keith Says Yes credit approval process helps me say yes, you're approved. So if you want new Chevys, yes! New Fords? Yes! Lifetime warranty? Yes! Come see me, Keith Powell, at Yes Chevy in Hurricane and Yes Ford in Huntington.
In the Puerto Rico shootout, West Virginia University women, 84, Charlotte, 56. Final score, Richmond, 77, Maine, 43.
We just want 30s from now on. Third down and three, and Dylan Hours takes the snap, and he doesn't get anything. He's going to be stopped at about the line of scrimmage, and that will bring up a fourth down and three for the Polar Bears. Ball marked at the 45-yard line. Flag on the play on the far side. Appears to be a penalty pending against the Polar Bears. John Lilly, given his option.
Illegal formation. Offense, 5 men in the backfield. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
So he cannot decline the penalty. 5-yard penalty, and it makes it third down and eight.
Haven't seen that one called in a while.
Illegal formation. The Polar Bears have now third down and 8 yards to go. The football at the Polar Bear 39, 2:58 turning clock, first quarter. Fairmont Senior 7, Independence nothing. They're crowding the line of scrimmage on this third down play. Ryder getting pressure, chased out of the pocket, and he's sacked back at the 25-yard line.
Yeah, they just bring the pressure. They're not trying to disguise it. I mean, you can tell who's coming.
Number four, pretty right here in Baltimore.
So.
Brought down by number 29.
Yeah, we had a left guard to block down on the nose and left backer running through the.
Miles Greenway with it. Quarterback sack, and that takes the ball all the way back to the 26-yard line, and it's a fourth down and 20 for the Polar Bears, and Hours will be doing the punting from left to right. He gets a good snap, punts it away, line drive punt, and it goes over the head of Linksweiler, and it's rolling down inside the 10, and it's going to be down at about the 8-yard line.
Wow, I don't understand why he did that, Jeff.
Number 10, Cannon Dinger, well, was down the ball for Fairmont.
He definitely looked like he could have caught that.
Trying to put it down at the 8-yard line. That makes it a 66-yard punt for Dylan Hours, which will be a career high for him. As a punter, he averages about 33 yards per punt. Now, with 2:04 to go in the first quarter, Independence is deep in its own territory, and it certainly wants to avoid a mistake here. First and 10. At the Indy 8-yard line.
You know, possession before they start at the 20, this possession, they're inside the 10. So far, we're winning the, field position game.
Quarterback up under center now, and the Polar Bears have jumped off sides. Exactly what you don't want to do as the defense. You've been given great field position as a defense, and you jump off sides on a first down play.
Yeah, you definitely want to just help
them. Ball, encroachment, defense number 55. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Trevor Bigelow jumping from his defensive line position on the end, and it's now first down and 5 for the Patriots. Now they have three backs in the backfield, and the handoff goes off the left side, and there's not much running room for Bradford.
26, Linksweiler, the ball carrier.
Bradford carries it up to about the 14-yard line.
Yeah, they got some type of short yardage situation with power eye right, or sorry, power eye left, and just ran ISO, 45 ISO.
1 yard gain, and it will be second down and 4 for the Patriots. Wide out to the left side, right out to the right, and the quarterback hands it off to Linksweiler, and he'll carry the football out over the 15-yard line to about the 17.
You know, it was a nice play by Canfield, number 2, coming over the top, making that play, or they could have had some major yardage on this play.
Third down and a yard to go. Canfield has made 2 plays back-to-back, stopping the runner for short yardage, and it's going to be third down and 1 now. The ball is at the 17-yard line.
Inside 1 minute to go, opening quarter. Polar Bears 7, Independence nothing. And the quarterback hands the ball off the right side to Bowers, and he's going to be brought down behind the line of scrimmage. And it's going to bring up a fourth down for the Patriots and a punting situation in their own territory.
Yeah, nice job by our D-line.
At the 17. Bracero in on the tackle for the Polar Bears. Now the officials are calling time.
Officials time out.
I guess maybe they want to measure.
Chick-fil-A and its 18 West Virginia owner-operated restaurant
yeah.
salute the more than 86,000
So they will bring the chains in from the far side. Actually, I thought the ball was farther back than it was on the play before that.
It looked like it. But, you know, that was a nice play by number 40.
That prepare each participant for life. The same values that Chick-fil-A in your community share.
Ooh, doggy.
It is short of a first down by about a foot.
What do you do, Jeff?
Yeah, how much of a gambler is John Lilly here?
After the measurement, it'll be fourth down for Independence.
Well.
They're bringing.
It looks like you're on point.
They're bringing out some of their key players. And the putter is the quarterback, so that's never a good indication of what's happening, but the putter is back at the 5 yard line. Polar Bear front line digging in now as Auer stands at his 50.
Good ball.
Good snap. Takes a lot of time and he gets it away, but it's not a really good putt. And it hits at the Indy 40 and just dies there.
Nice.
So that's just a 23 yard putt.
Yep.
For Nelson, and the Polar Bears have excellent field position with 18 seconds to go in the first quarter and a 7-0 lead.
You know, maybe Coach Lilly knew what was going to happen. He might have went for it if he knew he was going to get a punt like that.
Yeah, that's like one offensive play.
Yeah.
You know, you get a first down and you're pretty much back where they were before.
Yes, sir.
So now Fairmont with the ball. First down and 10. At the Independence 40-yard line, moving from left to right, all in the center of the field, and Whitehair is back to pass. Has time over the middle. Beautiful catch by Dinger at the 27-yard line, and it's a Fairmont first down.
They did a nice job up front. Again, they delayed, fired their middle backer. Brody made a nice throw over the middle, and Dinger is just, 10's just being 10.
Those are routine catches for him, and it's first and 10. Ball at the 27-yard line, and the first quarter has come to an end. After one quarter, from East West Stadium in Fairmont, it's the Fairmont Polar Bears 7, Independence nothing on Fun 93.1.
Since 1965, the team at City Construction has been an industry leader in all facets of construction, shaping the West Virginia landscape with some of the most recognizable commercial projects throughout the state. As one of the largest general contractors in North Central West Virginia, our outstanding record of quality workmanship and personal service is here for your next project. Call our team of experts today.
Give us the opportunity to design, build your next project. City Construction Company, West Virginia proud since 1965.
It's the start of the second quarter. The Polar Bears lead 7-0, have the football in Independence territory at the 27. Fairmont is a number 2 seed. Independence a number 14 seed, but a much better team than that. First down and 10, and Whitehair is back to pass. Screen pass comes to Auer. He catches it at the 25. He's at the 20. He's at the 15, the 10. Down to the 5, still running. He won't go down. That's a Polar Bear touchdown. Dylan Auer's catches the 27-yard touchdown pass from Brody Whitehair. He wasn't going down, and the Polar Bears lead it 13-0.
You know, Jeff, I'm pretty sure if you look back last week, he scored on the same play, screen pass right to Dylan. Hey, when five doesn't want to come down, he doesn't go down.
Not easily, that's for sure. And Peschel ready to attempt the extra point. Canfield is the holder. And the ball is down, and the kick is up, and the kick is good. And there's timeout on the field. 11:47 to go. Second quarter. It's Fairmont Senior 14. Independence nothing on Fun 93-1.
City National Bank, where you can purchase or refinance your home with the No Down Payment Champion Mortgage. No down payment, no private mortgage insurance, no kidding. Visit your local branch to get started today. City National Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. To learn more, log on to mortgage.bankatcity.com.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
In the first, Texas and Texas Tech score. On the kick.
Dylan Auer scores his second touchdown of the night. A little more exciting play than his 3-yard quarterback sneak. And the Polar Bears now lead by two touchdowns, and Peschel will kick off from right to left. Here is his kick, high, end over end. This one will be returned and dropped at the 10-yard line, but picked up there by Bowers, and he brings it out over the 20 and dives up to the 25-yard line.
You know, I can't say I've ever been in that position, but number one, Bowers, I know he muffed that kickoff right there, but he did the next best thing. He fielded it and got what he could.
So now the ball is at the 25. Independence has struggled offensively. They're only first down.
Well, we're definitely winning the field position so far.
Yeah, their only first down was by a pass interference penalty called against the Polar Bears. So first and 10 now.
Empty. Look for a one-on-one on up top there away from us, Jeff.
Here's the quarterback on a keeper up the middle, and he's tripped up, and he goes down after a gain of maybe a yard. That was Silas Nelson carrying.
Right down by number 55, Trevor Bigelow.
It'll be a gain up to the 22. Second down and 8. Two-yard gain.
They had quads over here, but they had Trey Bowers was the lone receiver over at the top. We see that formation again. Look for him to go for the one-on-one. Yeah, here it comes right here.
They wanted to look at it again. And they have Bowers split wide to the sidelines to the far side. And the quarterback, Nelson, back to pass. He sends it to the near side, and the ball's caught at the 25-yard line. Flag is down as it's taken over the 35 to the 37.
I think we're going to get a hold call here. Our number three, Boda, was being held.
Rex Foster is the referee.
Holding offense on the 13.
Holding is called on Christian Linksweiler, the receiver on the near side.
Yeah, he spun number three, Boda, in Fairmont Senior.
So that's going to take the football back. See where they set it down at the 17-yard line. Second down and 18 yards to go now. Ball back at the 17, and the quarterback on a keeper, maybe a broken play, and he is hit behind the line of scrimmage and going down. Yeah. Trevor Bigelow was on him quickly.
That was a great job by our defensive line.
Number 55, Trevor Bigelow
and Arbogast.
Number 14, Gavin Michaels. Be third and 20 for Independence.
2-yard loss on that carry. And now it's going to be third down and 20, and Independence is in another bad spot because if they have to punt, you know they're going to give up good field position again. So they really want to see if there's any way they can find Trey Bowers here and get a first down. And he's a wide out. He's in the slot to the left now.
Yep, he's in the slot.
Quarterback Nelson looking his way, throws the ball to the far side, and it is caught by Bowers, and Bowers is hit by Dinger at the 25-yard line, well short of the first down. And it'll be a fourth down and 10 coming up.
Yeah, that was a weird pass route. Being third and forever, he ran a 10-yard hitch.
counting on him to make something happen after he caught the ball, obviously.
Yeah.
That's short. Now punting situation. The line of scrimmage is the 25. And Nelson, again, takes so much time to get the putt away. It's high and ours drops it and falls on it back at the 41-yard line. So this has been a game of some errors. We've seen a muffed kickoff. We've seen a muffed punt. We've seen a fumble.
You know, and I, you know, going back to Trey Bowers on that kickoff and coming up now to Dylan, I think the temperature's got something to do with it. That ball's like an ice cube. You got to squeeze it.
And it is a cold night as you look down at the fans. It's a winter. It's a wintertime game tonight, that's for sure. First down and 10. Ball at the Fairmont 41, 9:22 on the clock. And Whitehair gives it to Ours. Ours trying to get outside to the left. Breaks a tackle there. Gets back to the line of scrimmage. And more. Up to the 45, the 50. And then dives into Patriot territory at the 49. Close to a Fairmont first down.
Yeah, you know, Five's having a good game tonight. That's all him on that run. We let the end, number 45, their best player, untouched, and Dylan was able to escape from him and gain a first down.
It's a 10-yard gain for Ours, who is now up to 52 rushing yards tonight. And it's first and 10 Polar Bears at the Independence 49 as the clock has turned inside 9 minutes to go in the first half.
Yeah, because watching tape, Hypes don't miss too many tackles.
In motion goes Canfield in front of the quarterback, and the handoff goes to Damani Johnson. Ooh, he is hit at the 48-yard line. Nice defensive play by Bradford there.
Yeah, Damani, you don't want to leave your feet, son.
They'll get a yard, and it's going to be second down and 9. Connor Bradford is a 5'8", 180-pound senior.
Yeah, he came up in support. You know, he's not accounted for in the run game, but he came downhill on that one.
Second and long for the Polar Bears now. Second down and 9 with three receivers to the right side. One receiver to the left. And Whitehair is back to pass, getting some pressure. It's picked up, and he's back to throw. Flag is down, and the pass to the near side is intended for Canfield. But there's a flag in the Polar Bear backfield.
I believe we're going to get holding on number 8, Damani Johnson.
They had a rusher coming, and Johnson was the last man. And he was able to get in front of him and protect his quarterback, but apparently did something illegal to protect him. Waiting for the call from the referee.
Holding, offense number 8, 10 yards from the previous spot.
So it'll be a 10-yard penalty from the Independence 48. So that will bring it back to the Fairmont senior, 41, which actually is an 11-yard penalty, but who's counting?
Those strike guys out there aren't counting.
So now it's second down and 20 to go for the Polar Bears. There's the little flip coming to Johnson off the right side, and Johnson doesn't get much. Maybe a yard or two. Stop on the play was made by Dalton Williams, 6'5", 200-pound senior for the Patriots.
Yeah, it was a nice play by Mr. Williams staying at home.
So a couple of yards on that pass play. 66 yards passing for Whitehair tonight. Third down and 18, though. Polar Bears haven't had one of these for a while. Three wideouts to the right side. One to the left. And Whitehair is back to pass. Sets up far side of the field. The pass is going to be intercepted at about the 45-yard line, and the Patriots will have the ball. Yeah. On the far side of the field.
You know, they only brought 3 on that, dropped 8. Yeah, they only rushed 3 and dropped 8. It was an overthrow by Brody for an interception.
So Bowers with the interception, and the Patriots had their best field position in a while. The ball's at the Independence 47, 7:13 on the clock. Fairmont senior 14, Independence nothing. The winner goes to the state title game next weekend in Wheeling.
Now it's first down and 10. High snap, brought down. Linksweiler being tracked down from behind, and Canfield's got him.
Nice.
Let's see here.
Look at that, open window. There was a window, and he stuck his face in it, Jeff. Nice play by the young man.
4 yard loss for Tyler Linksweiler, and he's back to 0 yards rushing tonight. He's had been tackled three times for losses. Second and 14, the ball back at the 43-yard line. Independence has Nelson back to pass, throws it to the far side, incomplete. Dylan Hours depending on the play, and the pass was intended for Peyton Bradbury.
Yeah, see the rebound. I mean, Dylan might have had a shot at it.
Number 5, Hours with the coverage. Third and 14 for Independence.
So now the Patriots have a third and long. Polar Bears front line has Bracero in the middle, flanked by Bigelow and Arbogast. Boda, Canfield, Michael, and Hours are linebackers.
All right, we got Bowers down here in the slot.
You always look for number one. And pass comes to Bowers. There's the flea flicker, comes back to the near side, taking it to 45, up to the 50, and short of the first down. It'll bring up a fourth down, and about 8 or 9 yards to go.
I'll tell you what, Jeff, that is, you know, as a defensive coordinator, I'm kind of smiling, because if they're going to go to that hook and lander this early in the game, then that means that they're not too sure what they can accomplish tonight offensively.
It's fourth down and 8 yards to go. So the play did result in some yardage, but they needed much more than they got.
Yeah.
Punting situation. Nelson to do the punting, gets the snap, punts it away, line drive, and it takes a hop, and Hours lets it bounce behind him, and it'll roll down close to the 5-yard line. Dylan's been snake bitten a little bit with some ball handling issues, and I don't think he wanted to try to catch that hard bounce that deep in his own territory.
Yeah, I think he played the weather, because in the previous games this season, Dylan would have snatched that.
So Fairmont with the football at its 6 with 5:36 to go in the second quarter, and the Polar Bears on top 14-0. Yep. Remember, Fairmont received to start the game, so they will kick off to start the second half.
This is an important possession for us down here. We want to at least get out of here and punt it away.
Here's Whitehair giving it to Hours off the right side, and Dylan is wrapped up at the line of scrimmage and then manages to get two or three up close to the 10-yard line.
That was a nice hard run by number 5.
It's going to be a gain of 4, second down and 6.
Tackle made by number 11, Landon Kremen.
Hours 56 yards rushing tonight for the Polar Bears, the leading rusher in the game. Ball up at the 10-yard line. 5 minutes to go in the first half. And now flag, the line of scrimmage, a delay penalty coming up against the Polar Bears. That was one that didn't feel like a delay. You know,
no.
Sometimes you can feel them, and I didn't feel that one.
Yeah, I wasn't paying attention in the last play when they started the play clock, but yeah, it seemed awful quick. But they're huddling up again.
Yeah, that's one of those things. I mean, when the play clock gets to 0, it's an automatic flag.
Yeah.
Just seemed like it didn't feel like one.
Okay.
Well, you and I, we got something right today.
Yeah, it just seemed awful quick.
So it's back to second down and 6. Play clock did not get reset. That was the reason. So now it's going to be second down and 6 for the Polar Bears at the 10-yard line. Hours behind Whitehair on this second down play. And here's Brody on a keeper off the right side. He gets to the 10, to 15. He's up to the 20. He's got the first down over the 25, up to the 27-yard line. And the Polar Bears get out of the hole.
Nice play by number 4.
Down by number 1, Trey Bowers.
You know, the last few weeks, Brody's been aiming when he runs to either slide or run out of bounds. This time, hey, he got us a first down.
So now with the clock turning inside 4:36 to go, the Polar Bears have a new set of downs. It's first and 10 at the 27. Fairmont 14, Independence nothing in the state semifinals here in Fairmont. White here back to pass. Sets up far side of the field. The pass is caught along the sidelines by Navon Jones, and then he steps out of bounds right at the first down marker.
I hope they're not going to give it to him.
They're going to give him a gain of 9. Make it second down and 1. 75 passing yards for Brody White here. His stats are just off the charts this season. He's thrown for 2,525 yards, 33 touchdowns. Second down and a yard to go from the 37. Hours gets it up the middle, and Hours crashes into the line and gets the first down up to the 39. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and Fairmont keeps the drive alive and has a first down, its 9th of the night.
Yeah, we got a nice push by our O-line. Wish Angeline could have stayed square, but hey, first down, we'll take it.
Arbogast over the ball at center. Richmond and Angeline are the guards. Dawson and Bigelow are the tackles. First down and 10, and Whitehair back to pass, getting pressure from behind, runs to the far side of the field. The ball pops loose, and it's fumbled, and Independence has recovered.
Yeah.
The ball is taken out of bounds at about the 32-yard line. That was the big guy, Micah Brown, 6'3", 310-pounder, who was in the right place at the right time when that ball popped straight up into the air. He got a hold of it.
That young man put his face mask on the ball, and that's what happens when you do that.
And it's going to be first down and 10 with 3:45 to go. What a change that is.
Well, it all started with the offensive line allowing penetration from their defensive line, and Brody was forced to evade to his right, and the young man from Independence made one pretty nice tackle to put his face mask on the ball.
3:45 left in the half, and there's a delay in the action as there's a flag on the play at the line of scrimmage.
And this is a very important possession for Independence. If I'm Independence, I'll at least want to, I want to put something on the board before halftime. I don't want to go down 14-0.
So that takes the ball back to the 37-yard line. It's going to be first down and 15 for the Patriots now.
One's in the slot up top.
Linksweiler is the running back alongside the quarterback. Bowers comes in motion, gets the handoff.
Stay with
halfback him. Pass, looking downfield. The pass is caught into the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah.
A halfback pass from a guy who was the quarterback. And the Polar Bears turnover turns into a touchdown for the Patriots.
Yeah, that was big for Independence. Now they're in their second trick play of the night, and that one went for it.
37-yard touchdown pass.
On the extra point for Independence, number 3.
And the extra point by Cuthbert is good. Cuthbert put it in, and there's timeout on the field with 3:36 to go in the second quarter from Fairmont. It's the Polar Bears 14, Independence 7 on FUN 93.1.
Here at the Cracker Barrel, homestyle food and great value go hand in hand. With favorites like slow simmered chicken and dumplings starting at $7.99. Or perfectly golden fluffy buttermilk pancakes with your own bottle of warm syrup. Come fill up on favorites without emptying your wallet. Cracker Barrel. Take care now.
Final score, double overtime. Utah State 44, New Mexico 41. Kicking off for Independence, number 3, Cuthbert. Back for Fairmont Senior, number 5, Dylan Hours. Number 2, Logan Cantor.
The kickoff taken at the 21-yard line by Dylan Hours, and he takes it out over the 35, the 40, and up to the 42-yard line.
Yeah.
And that'll be first and 10 for the Polar Bears with 3:29 on the second quarter clock.
Yeah, Dylan's put us in good field position here for the last 3:29 to go in the half.
If you're a Polar Bear fan, the glass half full from this whole scenario is you have the opportunity to take it down and score and get the 14-point lead again. That is if things go well. First and 10, Hours goes in motion out of the backfield, and Whiteair swings it over to him on the pass. He catches at the 40, gets outside to the 45. He's dangerous in the open field, and he goes out of bounds in Independence territory inside the 50-yard line.
Yeah, we got good blocking on the perimeter there at that time, and Dylan got caught from behind.
Tackle made by number 26, Linkswiler. Result of the play will be a Polar Bear first down.
Yeah, good blocking on the perimeter.
An 11-yard gain for the Polar Bears. Most of the passes tonight have been of the short variety. Now the Bears have it at the 47 in Independence territory, first down and 10. And there's quarterback. This time it goes to Hours. Hours runs wide to the right side, takes it inside the 45, down to about the 42. He'll get about five on the play before he was hit and brought down near the sidelines on the far side of the field.
Yeah, they snuck Dylan in there as quarterback, and they just ran him in ISO keep.
Second and five for Fairmont Senior at the 42. Sidelines right. Open field to the left, and that's where the three receivers are on the second down play. Whiteair, back to pass, over the middle. The pass caught by Canfield at the 35-yard line, and he's going to be brought down on the spot, but it'll be enough for a Fairmont Senior first down. Canfield making the catch for a Fairmont Senior first down. And that was Linksweiler with the tackle.
And that was a nice play by Canfield. And nice catch. Brody threw a catchable ball. But, Jeff, we need to get Gavin Michael involved on offense here.
First and 10, Fairmont. Handoff goes to Damani Johnson. Hit at the line of scrimmage. Breaks free inside the 35, the 30. Down the sidelines at the 20. That's the 15, the 10, the 5. He's out of the end zone. It's a Polar Bear touchdown. But there's a flag on the play back at the 30.
Usually I scan for those. You did that time.
Yes. Yes. Seen enough of these long plays called back, and that was a beautiful run by Damani Johnson.
Sure was. Made up for that holding call you got a few minutes ago.
Holding, offense number 14.
Well, I didn't mean Gavin to get involved that way.
Gavin Michael called for the hold. It'll be a 10-yard penalty assessed from the spot of the foul. So that means that it's going to come back to the 39. The spot of the foul was the 29. And that made that run by Johnson a 5-yarder. So it's going to be first down and 15 for Fairmont now at the Independence 39 with 2:17 to go in the half. Canfield comes in motion, and Whiteair, little swing pass far side, caught by Hours. Hours is hit along the sidelines at about the 36-yard line and goes down. It'll be a short gain of about 3 yards on the play.
Yeah, it's just that screen right that we scored on earlier tonight.
101 passing yards for Whiteair now. And it's second and 13 from the Independence 36-yard line. Fairmont 14, Independence 7. Whiteair back to pass, has lots of time over the middle. The pass is caught inside the 20-yard line. That's Gavin Michael, and it's a Polar Bear first down.
Yeah, I've been waiting for this one since the game started, getting the ball in the 14's hands. You know, other than our number 10 Dinger, 14's been a great receiver all for us all year.
First down and 10, Polar Bears, and a timeout called on the field now with a minute 29 to go in the second quarter. Timeout Independence. It's Fairmont 14, Independence 7 on Fun 93.1.
Hi, this is Meredith Mayer from Fairmont, West Virginia, and when I'm back home, you can find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that thundering herd pride at your local Parmar stores. We are over 200 stores strong and growing. Download the Parmar app for even more savings and sign up for the Parmar Rewards Card. Whether it's food, gas, or groceries, we have you covered. We are Marshall and we are Parmar Stores.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
Here at the Cracker Barrel, homestyle food and great value go hand in hand with favorites like slow simmered chicken and dumplings starting at $7.99 or perfectly golden fluffy buttermilk pancakes with your own bottle of warm syrup. Come fill up on favorites without emptying your wallet. Cracker Barrel, take care now.
The scoreboard clock. No, they say just 2 seconds, so it goes to 131 from 129. And the Polar Bears go first and 10 from the 17. Sidelines right. A lot of room to run on the left. Two receivers to the right side. Michael and Canfield. Wider to pass down over the middle. The pass is caught in the end zone. It's a Polar Bear touchdown. Brody Whitehair to Cannon Dinger. And Fairmont scores and leads it 20-7.
You know, Jeff, that all started with the pass protection. Now they even brought a five-man pass rush. We held it off good. Great route by Dinger. Good pass by Brody. 6 points.
And now it's Cam Peschel to attempt the extra point, and it's a good kick. So Peschel gets the extra point, and with a minute 25 to go in the first half, the Polar Bears lead it now 21-7. Gives us a chance to check what's going on around the state.
I'm Keith Powell, and going on right now is my Keith Says Yes Fest. I'm saying yes to lowering your payments, yes to your trade-in, regardless of condition, miles, even if you're still making payments. My Keith Says Yes credit approval process helps me say yes, you're approved. So if you want new Chevys, yes. New Fords, yes. Lifetime warranty, yes. Come see me, Keith Powell, at Yes Chevy in Hurricane and Yes Ford in Huntington.
That's a 7:30 game tomorrow night, Tuesday. That's a late game for semifinal weekend. And then in AAA, take a look at this score. Princeton 27, Bridgeport 7 in the second quarter. And it was tied 7-7 the last time I looked, just a few minutes ago. The other AAA matchup is tomorrow. That's Martinsburg on the road at Huntington.
Jeff, if I remember, I think Princeton came up here in the regular season and beat Bridgeport last year. So sounds like the Tigers have a good formula for beating the single wing.
That formula is well hidden, too. There's an end over end high kick by Peschel, and Bowers gets it at the 10. Comes this way, gets out over the 15, the 20, the 25, the 30, and up to the 35 yard line, and that'll be the end of that run.
All right, for Blue, we just want to, we don't want to give up any points right here. Okay, we can give up yards, we just don't want to give up points.
The other thing to remember is that Independence has had to use two timeouts here in the first half. So Independence has just one timeout left and a minute 18 on the clock, and they trail 21-7, but they do know they get the ball to start the second half.
Yeah.
They send the two receivers left and two to the right, and here's quarterback Nelson on a run, takes it up the middle, and he gets it up to about the 45-yard line. That'll be about all. He was hit and brought down there by Gavin Michael. Gain of about 5-6, make it second down and 4.
Now, first down, they just ran quarterback draw, or quarterback iso, however you want to call it. Again, we don't want to give up any points here. We can give up some yards, we just don't want to give up points.
And you just keep your eyes on that number one, that Trey Bowers. Quarterback sends it to the far side, and the pass is caught at the 45-yard line, and that is it. There is no gain at all on that play, and the clock's going to turn down inside 30 seconds as Linksweiler caught the pass, but Dylan Hours brought him down, a gain of a yard.
Yeah, Dylan made a nice open field tackle here and gave up more yards. Third and short. Well, they might be content with just going into halftime now, Joe.
Well, and knowing third down and short, and you don't want to give the ball back, the Polar Bears would have called timeout.
Here we go.
3 seconds.
He's back up.
And the quarterback just back to throw, getting some pressure. Sends it downfield, and the pass is intercepted. Dingo has it at the 39. He comes this way, gets up to the 50, runs down the sidelines, and he's out of bounds at about the 46-yard line. And the all-time leader in pass interceptions in Fairmont senior history closes out the first half with a pass interception. It's halftime from East West Stadium in Fairmont. In the semifinal round, the score, Fairmont Senior 21, Independence 7. And a halftime report coming up next on Fun 93.1.
An injury at any age can be a game changer. But with walk-in clinics Monday through Saturday, the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute is ready to get you off the bench and back in the game. Marshall Sports Medicine Institute takes care of the herd. Let us take care of you.
Hi, my name is Zach Frazier, and I'm from Fairmont, West Virginia. And when I'm back at home in Fairmont, you'll find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that gold and blue pride at Parmar. There are literally hundreds of Parmar stores in West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, and even more on the way. Download the Parmar app to save even more. And whether it's food, gas, groceries, or whatever, we have you covered at Parmar. West Virginia proud and ready to serve you.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
Hi, this is Meredith Mayer from Fairmont, West Virginia, and when I'm back home, you can find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that thundering herd pride at your local Parmar stores. We are over 200 stores strong and growing. Download the Parmar app for even more savings and sign up for the Parmar Rewards Card. Whether it's food, gas, or groceries, we have you covered. We are Marshall, and we are Parmar stores.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
John Snyder. Please welcome our drum major, Shay White, our band commander, Landon Rowan, assistant band commander, Braz Evans IV. The section leaders include Sierra Matheny, Aliana Noriega Freeman.
It's halftime at East West Stadium in Fairmont, where the Polar Bears hold the lead over the Independence Patriots by a score of 21-7. We talked coming into this game about the disparity in the ratings. Fairmont has the number 2 team in Class AA, Independence number 14, and the Patriots have played better than that, but they got off to a slow start. They were 2-3 at one point in the season, and so rallying from that is difficult to do. They finished at 14, but they disposed of their first two opponents pretty easily. But tonight they're up against something that it doesn't look like they've seen for a while, because offensively they're struggling to move the football.
Yeah, you know, really the touchdown they got was a halfback pass. So really defensively we've kept them in check. We've won the field possession. We've had great field possession except once, Dylan let the ball roll by him. But that's very important in any game, let alone the state semifinals. So defensively, if I'm Coach Bardick, I'm happy. Just keep everybody in front of you, knowing later in the second half, they're going to have to, force the ball into number one's hands more. I don't know if they can do it. We'll see.
And I did notice that prior to the game, they were running him in some of their pregame practices, or when they're running through their drills down on the field when they had their first team offense out. He took several snaps at quarterback, and I kept thinking, well, maybe they're thinking that they might be using him as quarterback tonight if that situation arises. And certainly they're getting into a situation where it might, because they want to get the ball in his hands. And as a receiver, sometimes that's hard to do.
Yeah, he's by far the best player for Independence, and we definitely want him to have as many touches as possible. And bringing him in off the slot, jet slot, and have him throw a touchdown pass, that was the play. You know, play as wide receivers got behind our DB and made the catch and got seven. And we'll just have to wait and see. As a defense coordinator, you're like, you know, they've already ran the hook and ladder. And they've hit us with a halfback pass. You know, those are gimmick plays. You know, just wait and see. So far, our defense has stand tall.
The one downside for the Polar Bears in the first half was ball security, because they fumbled on their very first possession, which looked like it could have been a disaster because it was in Fairmont territory where Independence started. And we're talking about 15 seconds into the game. It was the first play of the game. And then there was another fumble by Brody White here where it looked as though the Polar Bears were driving to maybe go down and put another touchdown on the board and go in up by maybe a 21-0 score or a 14-0 score, but certainly up by two touchdowns. And then, of course, Brody threw the interception. That was, though, on a long yardage situation. That wasn't as big a deal. But Fairmont has three first-half turnovers. That's not the recipe for success, and they can't do that again in the second half.
Oh, by no means they can't. You know, we've had three turnovers. One's come back and bit us. The most important drive so far that we've had the first half was our last drive when we drove down there and answered and went back up 14. Because at that moment in time, Mojo was over here with Independence, and we've kind of zapped them. You know, our guys went into the locker room here a few moments ago, excited and happy. Not I want to say happy. They went in very excited.
You mentioned the momentum, the mojo, as you called it, and I can't help but think of this game last year down there where Fairmont came out of the locker room in the second half trailing 12-0, very similar to what Independence is facing now. Fumbled the first kickoff away and fumbled the next kickoff away. Independence turned both of those into touchdowns, and that 12-point game all of a sudden was a 28-point Independence lead and pretty much just ended the game with that momentum shift at the start of the second half.
Yeah, turnovers, you know, regular season, preseason, postseason, turnovers will zap you as a football team. You know, I've always said the most important minutes of any game is the first 4 minutes of the first half and the first 4 minutes of the second half. So we'll see if we come out here in the second half and make Independence go three and out, or not even three and out. You know, if we can hold them scoreless on their opening drive of the second half, it's great news for us.
Okay, tell me what's going on in the Independence locker room right now, because if they take a look at what they've done offensively in the first half, there was really only one play that showed any success, and it was the halfback pass. Their running game has pretty much been non-existent, and they have relied on a pretty solid running game this season. What are they trying to come up with at halftime to try to get their offense moving?
Well, Coach Lilly's not going to try to reinvent the wheel. You know, he's in there right now telling these guys, look, we're down 14 points. We get the opening kickoff. We're going to come back out. We're going to establish a run game. And we're going to go down and score and bring it within seven, and then we'll go from there. You know, he's not in there drawing plays up, you know, on the chalkboard. He's just trying to reset his team because, you know, second half, it's the same as the first half. And we're both 24 minutes. So, you know, by no means is this a guaranteed Fairmont senior win right now. It looks real good for us, Fairmont senior win right now. But right now, that first possession, that first 4 minutes of that second half is going to tell us a lot.
And for both sides, because like we talked about momentum, if Fairmont would be able to hold Independence on its first possession without getting the ball maybe into Polar Bear territory, force a punt, then you've got the ball with a chance to even extend the lead even more, and the momentum really seems to be in your favor then. And
yeah,
for Independence, it's just kind of the opposite. It's not a do-or-die situation. I mean, you know, they don't have to score on their first possession of the second half, but I think they do need to put a little bit of a drive together to keep themselves from having to give the football up in good field position for the Polar Bears and go through that thing in the second half that they saw in the first half.
Yeah, you know, Independence has good offense, and their offense is good enough to overcome a 14-point deficit. If we come out, kick off, and hold them scoreless on their first possession, and then we go in and punch up another one and go up 21, now Independence is going to be in some trouble because they don't really have an offense that explosive enough
for a 21-point deficit.
At least what we're seeing tonight doesn't indicate that.
Yeah, now you throw in, you know, turnovers, fumbles. Yeah.
So yeah. The Polar Bears have the lead here at the half, 21-7. Pretty good crowd here for this coldest game of the season here at the stadium. The Polar Bear Band, despite the cold temperatures, on the field performing as it did last week in the rain in the game against Philip Barber. We're going to go down and pick up music from the band as they close out their halftime show. Marching band of Fairmont Senior High School, directed by John Schneider, making its way off the field as we're about midway through halftime here at East West Stadium in Fairmont. We don't have a lot of scores to tell you about at the half, but we're going to do that, and we're also going to tell you about the first half stats when the halftime continues from East West Stadium in Fairmont. The state semifinals, the score, Fairmont Senior 21, Independent 7 on FUN 93.1. Yes. Do you remember when
I think it was a handoff.
It's a cold night at East West Stadium in Fairmont, but there was enough excitement to keep the fans moving a little bit in the first half. Both teams had some big plays. Polar Bears had a couple of more and have a 2-touchdown lead here at the half, 21-7. We talked about what's going on in the state playoff situation this weekend, and we're in the semifinals, so that means there's just a handful of teams left, obviously four in each classification. And in Class AA, the championship round isn't going to be decided until late tomorrow evening because one round will be completed. Of course, this game will be finished, but the North Marion game with Weir is not until 7:30 tomorrow night. So we won't know who the other opponent is going to be. If it's Fairmont Senior, it would be Fairmont Senior versus Weir or North Marion. And if Independence comes back and wins this game, the Patriots would be watching that scoreboard tomorrow night. So we're down to the four teams, Weir, North Marion, Fairmont, and Independence, and we'll eliminate one team here this evening. And then in Class AAA, There is a game going on tonight, and then there's another game tomorrow. Martinsburg and Huntington tomorrow. But the game tonight is the one where Bridgeport is playing Princeton, and the Indians are trailing by 20, 27-7 at the half. You know, everybody always says you want to get Bridgeport down by more than a touchdown or two and force them out of their game. Well, the Princeton Tigers have done a pretty good job of that. Halftime leading by 20 over a Bridgeport team that likes to take the ball from one end of the field to the other, but chew up about 6 to 8 minutes of clock time in the process. So the Indians struggling at Princeton, and the Tigers would love to make it to the state championship game and face either Martinsburg or Huntington. And of course, in Class Single A, we had one final earlier today, 45-8 win for Williamstown over Tucker County. Greenbrier West is leading James Monroe. James Monroe is the number one team in Class Single A, even though Greenbrier West is 12-0, James Monroe 10-1. But Greenbrier West is leading 7-0, and they're now into the third quarter of that game. So that's where things stand on the state side of things with the playoffs. This is the third round. This means this is the final time the Polar Bears will play on this field, of course, regardless of what happens tonight. The next and last game will be played at Wheeling Island Stadium. And it could be interesting if North Marion would win and Fairmont Senior would win. It would be a rematch of a game played in 1981 when those two teams played for the state title at Laidley Field in Charleston. That's where the championships were at that time. And the Polar Bears and the Huskies played, and North Marion came away with a 21-6 win in that game, an afternoon game at Laidley Field in Charleston. When we come back, it'll be time to check in with first half stats as halftime continues. From East West Stadium, it's the Polar Bears 21, Independence 7 on FUN 93.1.
In women's basketball, 3:22 left in the contest. Illinois State 72, University of Texas Arlington 57 at the St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic. 7 seconds left in the game. Cal State Bakersfield 62, Long Island University 57. And in the third, UCLA 46, UConn 37 in the Cayman Islands Classic.
How much time?
In the third, Greenbrier West 7, James Monroe 4, James Monroe 0. That's in the third. Final.
Okay, I'll be right back.
45, Tucker County 8. In AAA action tomorrow, number 3, Martinsburg travels to number 2, Huntington. And in double-A action tomorrow evening, 7:30, number 5, Weir, travels to number 1, North Marion.
Oh, mama, I'm in fear for my life in the Lord.
And ABC this evening in the second, Texas, 17, Texas Tech, 7.
Lawman is putting in to my running, and I'm so far from my home.
Halftime winding down at the stadium in Fairmont. The Polar Bears with a 21-7 lead over the Independence Patriots, who come into this game with a record of 8 wins and 3 losses, but they finished the season strong after starting the year at 2-3. Take a look at what the Patriots did. Not only did they turn things around, but then they went on a shutout binge. They shut out their last 4 opponents. Westside 55-0, Mann 38-0, Nicholas 46-0, and Wyoming East 68-0. That's what Independence did after losing to Bluefield 43-21, and that gave them a record of 2-3. Well, since that time, they won four games in the regular season, two in the postseason. They're on a six-game winning streak, and that includes five shutouts. So that tells you something about the Polar Bears' opposition here tonight. Let's check the first half stats. First downs, Independence has two, one by penalty, one by pass. The Polar Bears have 11. Rushing yards, Fairmont 102, Independence 12. Through the air, the Polar Bears have completed 12 of 14 passes for 135 yards, one interception, and two touchdowns. Independence has completed 4 of 7 passes for 53 yards, one touchdown, no interceptions. Total offense, Fairmont 237, Independence 65. Leading ground gainer, the quarterback, Silas Nelson, for Independence, 11 yards on 5 carries. Their leading rusher, Tyler Linksweiler, 0 yards on 5 attempts. On the Fairmont side, it's Dylan Hours with 61 rushing yards on 9 carries. Brody Whitehair, 3 carries for 23. Recapping the scoring, it was Fairmont on the scoreboard first. Dylan Hours ran it in, quarterback sneak, 3 yards out, 6:06 to go. Specials extra point made it 7-0. And then the Polar Bears went on top 14-0 at the beginning of the second quarter as Hours caught a 27-yard touchdown pass from Whitehair. Extra point by Peschel made it 14-0. After a Polar Bear turnover, it was Independence turn to come up with a big play, and it was a halfback pass from Trey Bowers, and he threw it to Taylor Dove. It was a 37-yard TD. Extra point by Cuthbert is good. 14-7 was the score, but the Polar Bears did manage near the end of the first half, just under 2 minutes to go, as Cannon Dinger caught a 17-yard touchdown pass from Whitehair. Peschel's extra point was good, and the Polar Bears went on top 21-7, and that is the score here at the end of the first half, and just about set for the beginning of the second half here at East-West Stadium. Having a meeting at the center of the field, this is the formality where the captains will meet and make the determination primarily of which side you're going to start out on, and it'll be Independence receiving, and they will be returning from left to right. Polar Bears kicking off with their backs to the little scoreboard here at East-West Stadium in Fairmont. Down below on the fence in front of the Polar Bears fan section, you see pictures of the senior players, and there are only 9 seniors this season, but among those 9 are some pretty big names, and one of those is Dylan Hours, another Gavin Michael. Those two have just they have had such outstanding careers for the Polar Bears, and you just take a look at those individual signs down there, and you see with Dylan, you think of all the games he's played for the Polar Bears, and Gavin with the improvement he's made as a player as well. Luke Abrazino, of course, out for the season after an ACL. Dakota Nisley, Josiah Jones, Caleb Angeline, Jerry Richmond, a player who's just been a solid performer for the Polar Bears, along with Riley Green and Tavion Thornton, who came out of nowhere playing football for the first time, became a starter defensively and a very important part of this team. Those are the Polar Bears seniors playing their final game on this field, regardless of the outcome of tonight's game. So the Polar Bears are going to be kicking off, and it will be Independence, the Patriots, returning. Coming into this game tonight, Brody Whitehair had 33 touchdown passes. He's added 2 to give him 35. You take a look at the record book. Whitehair came into this game tonight 4th in career passing with 4,729 yards. He's added about 100 to that, which puts him about 482 yards behind Dominic Smith, who is 3rd all-time in Fairmont history. And Dylan Hours moved over 2,000 rushing yards in his career last week. He's now at 2,145, which puts him behind Noah Harmon, who's in fifth place all-time polar bear rushers. The Polar Bears are going to kick off to start the second half, and the ball is going to be teed up on the far hash marks, and it's going to be Cannon Dinger who's going to kick off from right to left. They like to keep the ball away from Bowers, but then you look on the other side and you see Linksweiler and you think, I don't want to kick it there either. So we'll see what Cannon Dinger does now for the Polar Bears as the second half is ready to get underway. And here is his end-over-end kick. It is short, and it is going to hit along the sidelines and then roll out of bounds. That wasn't the plan.
No, you hate to see that to start the second half, Jeff.
No, I'm not exactly sure whether he was trying to kick it short or whether he just mishit it. So that puts the ball at the 35-yard line. I'm sure Independence is happy to see that because that's pretty good initial starting position for their first drive of the second half.
All right, here we go. That first 4 minutes, we'll see.
You keep your eye on the clock and tell me when 4 minutes is up, and then I'll relax, okay? Yeah. Fairmont digs in along the offensive line. Rosero in the middle. Bigelow on one side. Arbogast on the other. First down and 10 from the Independence 35-yard line. Bowers in the backfield. And the quarterback on a keeper almost mishandled the ball, but he gets big running room, gets it out over the 45 and up close to the 50-yard line. He's going to get a first down on a gain of about 15 yards.
You know, they came back and showed us that, you know, that split flow zone with the tailbacks, and the quarterback kept it.
So that's the longest gain of the night on the ground for the Patriots. It's a 15-yard run for the quarterback, and it's their third first down.
Yep. We got to see. It was a good play.
Wide out to the near side.
Here we go, same formation.
They have Bowers in the backfield. They send Dove in motion. And here's the quarterback on a keeper again. This time Bigelow's got him as he takes it inside the 50 to the 48-yard line. He'll get a yard, maybe two on the play.
Nice job by Bigelow and Arbogast.
Going to call it a gain of one and make it second down and nine. Ball at the 49 in Fairmont territory. Fairmont 21, Independence 7. Wide out to the near side. That's Christian Linksweiler. And Bowers is in the slot to the right on the second and nine. Silas Nelson, the quarterback. Long count at the line of scrimmage. Play clock at five. He hands it off to Linksweiler, wide to the left side. And Linksweiler has some room down the sidelines inside the 40, the 30. And Whitehair knocks him out of bounds inside the 20-yard line.
Yeah, Brody made a game. Brody, he saved a touchdown here.
34-yard run for Linksweiler. And just like that, the Patriots have come alive offensively. They've done as much in the start of the second half as they did in the entire first half as far as stats go. And it's first down and 10 at the Polar Bear 15. Quarterback hands, keeps it off the right side, and he takes it down inside the 10 to about the 9. Grabbed by the ankles there, but much too much on first down. Gavin Michael made the tackle. He's now wearing number 88. If you're watching this game on the stream and you wonder who is that guy, it's Gavin Michael, who was wearing 14 for the Polar Bears.
Yeah, they just faked zone and came back with quarterback counter. You know, we was talking, you know, I talked about, you know, they have the offense to stay, you know, 14 points is, you know, they got the offense to come back and tie this game up.
Quarterback on a design keep again, Nelson, and he's hit at the line of scrimmage and then falls forward for a yard, maybe two. Going to bring up a third down and about 3 yards to go. Logan Canfield makes the tackle for the Polar Bears.
Yeah, if they can punch it in here, we got us a game.
Third down and two, ball at the 8-yard line. They can get a first down, obviously, inside the 10. Under center, the quarterback hands it off to Tyler Linksweiler, wide to the left side, and he gets the corner turned close to the first down marker on the far side of the field, and it looks as though he will have enough for an Independence first down as he takes the ball inside the 5.
Yeah, well, Linksweiler does a nice job of gaining the edge.
Carson Gore, Independence.
So first down, goal to go. Football at the 3-yard line. 9:24. Clock stopped on that out-of-bounds play. Patriots come to the line of scrimmage. Linksweiler alongside Nelson, and Linksweiler gets the handoff off the left side, and he'll be brought down at about the 2. Get maybe a yard on the play.
Good play by Arbogast.
So Arbogast gets him after a 1-yard gain, second and goal from the 2-yard line. Clock hasn't started. No. Now it does. Second down, goal to go from the 2-yard line. Quarterback up under center now. Three backs, power eye formation. Quarterback keeps it, fires it into the end zone, and the pass is incomplete.
Nice play by Dinger.
Cannon Dinger in the back of the end zone.
Kind of surprised over the call. You know, they've been, third down. We haven't been able to stop the run yet.
Certainly surprised me. They were hoping it would surprise the Polar Bears, but the pass intended for Williams goes incomplete. Third and goal from the 2.
This isn't going to be a pass.
Go back to the tight formation, full house backfield. And there is the handoff. It goes to Linksweiler off the right side, and he's into the end zone for the touchdown.
Yep. Guess what?
Bradford, rather, on the touchdown for Independence.
And we are 3 minutes into the second half. First 4 minutes, Jeff. We got us a ball game now.
So Independence will now attempt the extra point. Kick will go from left to right. The kick is up, and the kick is good. And there's timeout on the field with 9:01 to go in the third quarter from East West Stadium in Fairmont. It's Independence trailing the Polar Bears. Fairmont 21, Independence 14 on Fun 93.1.
Hi, my name is Zach Frazier, and I'm from Fairmont, West Virginia. And when I'm back at home in Fairmont, you'll find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that Golden Boot Pride at Parmar. There are literally hundreds of Parmar stores in West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, and even more on the way. Download the Parmar app to save even more. And whether it's food, gas, groceries, or whatever, we have you covered at Parmar. West Virginia proud and ready to serve you.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
Kicking off for Independence, number 3, Micah Cuthbert. Back deep for Fairmont Senior, number 2, Logan Campbell.
So the Patriots do exactly what they wanted to do on that first possession. They take it down, punch it in the end zone, and now trail by just one touchdown, kicking off from left to right. Cuthbert will kick from the center of the field. Polar Bears inch up. He doesn't kick deep. This is end over end short. And it's taken at the 20-yard line by Canfield. Gets up to the 30, the 35, and over the 35 to the 37-yard line where he is hit
Canfield
and brought down.
Yeah, hey, good return. Hey, we'll take that plus 35. Let's go. But, you know, we talked at halftime, you know, Independence has the offense. 14 points is not a guaranteed, you know, guaranteed win for us.
And the
first 3 minutes of the second half being part of the 4 minutes, they went down and drove and scored. So we got to see how Fairmont responds.
First down and 10 from the Polar Bear 37-yard line. Dylan Hours has been the standout rushing so far tonight for the Polar Bears. Whitehair back to pass, getting lots of pressure. Now runs towards the sidelines. He's running with it and tries to get back to the line of scrimmage as he runs out of bounds.
Yeah, we had a guy, Canfield, I believe, was down the other sideline, wide open, but Brody didn't see him.
That's a 1 yard gain, and it's going to be second down and 9, ball at the 38. Thornton and Johnson are wideouts to the left side. Now we have an official's time.
Looks like we have an equipment malfunction.
D. Hypes, their outstanding linebacker, comes to the sidelines, gets something fixed. And the Polar Bears are looking at a second and 9 on the far hash marks as they move from right to left, closer to the right sidelines. And the handoff goes to Hours, trying to get outside to the left, trying to turn the corner, and he gets up to the 40-yard line, the 45, and then hit out of bounds at about the 47-yard line. Very close to a first down. See where they mark him out.
Very close. I think he's about a yard short. Yeah, nice play by Dillon about running number 7 to get the edge.
Now they signal first down, Polavir.
Yeah, first down.
But they had to call it from the near sideline and look all the way to the other sideline, and they say it was enough for a first down, a 9-yard gain for Dillon Hours, and the Polavirs have it at the 47. 70 rushing yards for Hours tonight. First down number 12 for the Polavirs. Three wideouts to the right, one to the left, and Hours lines up behind Whitehair. Brody back to pass, getting lots of pressure, runs to the far side of the field. Now just throws it towards the sideline and throws it out of bounds.
Pass intended for number 10, Cannon Dinger, will go incomplete.
Yeah, they're... You know, he rolled to his right. We had a guy coming that was open in the middle of the field running parallel with Brody. He just didn't see him.
He's had to be on the run a good bit tonight, not just set up in the pocket and throw, and that's what happened that time. Second down and 10 from the Fairmont 47-yard line. Whitehair gives it off to Hours, off to the right side. He's inside the 50, the 45, down to the 40, spun around, and then dives down to the 38-yard line. It's a Polar Bear first down on a 15-yard run by Dillon Hours.
Brought down by number 23, Connor Bradford. Result of the play is a Polar Bear first down.
Bradford makes the tackle for Independence, but it's not before Dillon Hours has a Polar Bear first down.
Great job by our offensive line getting the hat on the hat.
At the Independence, 38. The Polar Bears lead here 21-14. We're down to 8:05 to go in the third quarter. Fairmont trying to answer the last Independence touchdown. Dinger comes in motion. Handoff goes to Hours. Hours off the right side. He's at the 35. He's down to the 30. Tripped up and goes out of bounds beyond the first down marker on the far side of the field at about the 28-yard line.
You know, with that jet motion we just showed, it was more of a kind of a split flow. That split flow kind of held the backers a little bit, and Dillon was able to, with a good line block, and Dillon was able to get to the second level.
First and 10 now from the 28-yard line. Three receivers to the left, one to the right. Damani Johnson in the game now for the Polar Bears. Gavin Michael, the lone receiver to the right side. And here is the handoff to Johnson. Spins away from one defender. Wide to the left side, he's giving ground, then gets to the 25, and down inside the 25 is run out of bounds.
Nice little spin move.
Probably going to get about 3 yards on the play. Make it a second and 7 from the 20. Now call it the 24, so give him 4 yards and make it second down and 6 for the Polar Bears. Clock stopped, 7:41 to go here in the third quarter. Bridgeport now trails Princeton 27-14 in the third quarter of that game. Whitehair has two receivers left, two to the right. And now Brody back to pass. Looks to the far side of the field. Looks down. Throws in traffic, and it's incomplete. That was not the pass he wanted to throw. He had Gavin Michael open on the sidelines and threw to the wrong guy.
And Brody wishes he had that one back.
Number 10, Dalton Williams on the coverage.
Pass protection was there. We pick up the mic backer. Yeah,
out of the corner of your eye, you can see Gavin Michael, who was open along the sidelines, and now it's third down and 6 for the Polar Bears. Canfield lines up in the backfield alongside Whitehair on this important third down play, and Brody back to pass. Looks, throws to the far side of the field, now throws it, intending it in the area of Gavin Michael, but it's incomplete, and it's going to bring up a fourth down and long for the Polar Bears.
You know, we were already in two down territory. I don't know, you know, we just needed to get some of it.
So So now the ball is at the 25-yard line. Moved it back from the 24 to the 25. And it's going to be fourth down and six for the Polar Bears. They haven't been able to include Dylan Hours in the last couple of plays. He's been on the sidelines.
Yeah, you know, we could have had a manageable fourth and short.
Play clock. It needs to be reset when the play is over and then started. Please, 40 seconds.
So they're adjusting the play clock, and the Polar Bears have it at the 25-yard line, fourth down and six. Hours is back in the game alongside the quarterback, Brody Whitehair, on this fourth down play. And Whitehair is back to pass. Looks, sets up, fires downfield for Dinger. He's got it inside the five. It's a Polar Bear first down. Cannon Dinger catches the pass 22 yards from Whitehair, and the Polar Bears are first down and goal to go.
Yeah, Dinger comes open on the inside post move, and protection's there, and Brody made an excellent throw.
First down, goal to go, 3-yard line. Handoff goes to Hours, and he's tripped up behind the line of scrimmage at the four. Nice defensive play made by Landon Riddle, a 6-foot, 170-pound sophomore. And it's going to be second and goal for the Polar Bears. Ball comes back to the 4-yard line.
Yeah, they just ran, again, backers. Tell you what, Independence, when they fire their linebackers, they sure fire them.
Second and goal. Empty backfield now for quarterback Brody Whitehair. Takes the snap, and he's looking over the middle. The pass into the end zone. It is caught. It's a Polar Bear touchdown.
Nice. Nice way to come back and answer Independence, Jeff.
Logan Canfield catches the 5-yard TD pass from Brody Whitehair, and the Polar Bears go up on top by 2 touchdowns again. And for Logan Canfield, that's his third TD reception of the season.
You know, that was just a 3-man rush by Independence. They dropped 8 in the, you know, the short playing space that we had down there inside the 10.
Peschel's extra point is up, and it is good. And there's timeout on the field with 6:39 to go, third quarter. The Polar Bears 28, Independence 14 on Fun 93.1.
I'm Keith Powell, and going on right now is my Keith Says Yes Fest. I'm saying yes to lowering your payments, yes to your trade-in, regardless of condition, miles, even if you're still making payments. My Keith Says Yes credit approval process helps me say yes, you're approved. So if you want new Chevys, yes. New Fords, yes. Lifetime warranty, yes. Come see me, Keith Powell, at Yes Chevy in Hurricane and Yes Ford in Huntington.
20-7, and at the half, Nittany Lions 13, Spartans of Michigan State 0. So the Polar Bears do, in fact, answer the Independence touchdown with one of their own, and it's a 14-point lead again, 28-14, 6:39 to go. And Cannon Dinger to kick off from the far hash marks, and he sends this one high down the field, caught along the sidelines, juggled there by Bowers, and Bowers is going to be run out of bounds, and a late hit called it on the Polar Bears.
Yeah, that was not very smart by Fairmont Senior right there.
Did what he wanted to do. He kicked it close to the sidelines, and Bowers only had one way to go.
Nice contain. Yeah.
Along the sidelines, Dakota Nisley hit him late.
Can't do.
Kicking team number 25, 15 yards from the end of the kick, an ending run, first down, and a pick.
So no question about that call against Fairmont for personal foul along the sidelines.
Yeah, that was a legit call. You know, and it's a stupid, stupid play. I mean, we had him pinned up, and now we've almost given them field position midfield. So, hey.
Comes up to the 41 from the 26. 15-yard penalty, and it's first and 10, Indy, now.
There's number one, yeah. I believe he's the single over there.
Here's Nelson, the quarterback, getting the snap, and Hours got him, and he's brought down for a loss on the play.
Number 12, the ball carrier, tackle made by number 5, Hours.
Dylan Auer is getting a little southern exposure in this game tonight with the Polar Bears going up against Independence. Other fans getting a chance to see the quality player he is, and that's going to be a two-yard loss for their quarterback.
Big play for Fairmont Senior right there, Jeff, on first down.
So now we're back to a second and 12. Second and long, back at the 39-yard line in Fairmont territory. Nelson back to pass, getting pressure to the near side. The pass is incomplete, intended for Bowers. Dinger defending on the play, and it'll bring up a third down and 12.
You know, good pass rush by the blue. Good coverage by Dinger.
Bigelow, who does that a lot, gets pressure on the quarterback, maybe forces him to hurry his throw. And it's going to be third down and 12 coming up now. We look to see where Trey Bowers is. He lines up in the slot to the right. Third down and long. Nelson back to pass, and he's lofting one downfield long, and the pass is overthrown, incomplete.
Oh, a flag is thrown. That's a late one.
I don't know. I think there might have been there might be a little bit of. I just really don't think that that is a legitimate call. But yeah.
I think their feet got tangled up. But hey, is what it is. We just got to move on.
Yeah. But you can hear the crowd below us. The pass was overthrown, but uncatchable is not a call in high school football. That's not the point. But if there was contact made, there's a 15-yard penalty, and it's going to be first down for Independence. It's the second time that's happened to the Polar Bears tonight on a third down play.
Yeah. I mean, there was contact, but it was just that they stepped on each other's feet.
So it's going to be first down, Patriots, at the 46-yard line in Fairmont territory. And the handoff goes to Linksweiler. Linksweiler sees a little hole and gets inside the 45 to about the 43-yard line, where he is hit by Gavin Michael. Boda also there for the Polar Bears, a 3-yard gain, and it'll be second down and 7.
Nice play by Gavin. Got off his block and came down the line, made the field. And Brody got in there low. Most physical we've seen him all year.
So it's going to be second down and 7 from the Fairmont 43. 5:10 to go in the game, in the third quarter. The Polar Bears lead by 2 touchdowns. Long count at the line of scrimmage. Polar Bears don't jump. And there is the snap, and there's the quarterback keeper off the left side. And he gets an opening and takes it inside the 35, down to the 34-yard line. And it'll be a first down for the Patriots.
Yeah. Delayed snap and ran quarterback counter. Nice job by the white hats. White helmets getting a hat on the hat.
First down number 7 for Independence now. The ball at the Polar Bear 34, first and 10, Fairmont 28, Independence 14. But the Patriots threatening. And there is the quarterback on a keeper again, and Auer swallows him up at about the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, that's the second time. That's the second time this half Dylan's come in off the edge.
They'll give him a yard, and it's going to be second down and 9 at the Fairmont 33. Christian Linksweiler is a wide out to the near side. Trey Bowers in the slot to the left. And quarterback Nelson back to pass. He's launching one downfield deep, and there's nobody there.
Yeah, it's just miscommunication on the Patriots' part right there.
Christian Linksweiler's talking to the bench as he's coming back, trying to say, hey, I didn't think that's what I was supposed to do.
Yeah.
Third down and 9 coming up.
It's an important time of the game right here to have miscommunication like that.
Patriots looking at a third down and 9. Last time they had this, they got the Polar Bears into a pass interference situation and took advantage of it. About 15 yards and a first down. Now, third down and 9. Swing pass far side, caught by Bowers along the sidelines, and he's going to be brought down for very little. Catch it at about the 30-yard line, but he's going to be short of the first down.
Yeah. Nice job by our defense for corralling him and keeping him from not gaining any more yards after the catch.
Just a 3-yard gain, and it brings up a fourth down for the Patriots. Have it at the Fairmont 30, and they need to get it just inside the Polar Bear 30-yard line to about the 29.
This is a big play for Independence, Jeff.
Fourth down and six. Wide out to the near side. Quarterback Nelson sends Linkswiler in motion out of the backfield. He's back to pass, getting pressure. Sends it downfield, and the pass is caught by Linkswiler alone along the sidelines. Pushed out of bounds. No, he's into the end zone first. It's an Independence touchdown.
And we had a snafu there on defense. He's wide open.
Linkswiler came in motion out of the backfield, and nobody picked him up.
Yeah. Miscommunication in the back end of our defense. Just gave up 6 points.
Yard touchdown pass, and the extra point by Cuthbert is up, and it is good. Timeout on the field. 3 minutes, 4 seconds to go in the third quarter. Fairmont Senior 28, Independence 21 on Fun 93.1.
Hi, my name is Zach Frazier, and I'm from Fairmont, West Virginia. And when I'm back at home in Fairmont, you'll find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that Golden Boot Pride at Parmar. There are literally hundreds of Parmar stores in West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, and even more on the way. Download the Parmar app to save even more. And whether it's food, gas, groceries, or whatever, we have you covered at Parmar. West Virginia proud and ready to serve you.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
Single-A championship game will be played Saturday night at 7 o'clock.
Independence has found its offense in the second half of this game after struggling in the first half, managing just one touchdown. The Patriots have scored twice here in the third quarter and trail now by just a single touchdown, 28-21. Cuthbert will kick off from left to right. He kicks them short. This is a little squib kick, and fortunately for the Polar Bears, there was a flag on the play. It was a squib kick that had hit one of the Polar Bear players. That was Tavion Thornton. It bounced back into the area where Independence was going to recover it, but they were offsides on the kick.
Yeah, we got lucky. You know, got lucky there, Jeff.
And that's situation. You're one of those guys. You want to let that ball go behind you.
Yes.
Not have it bounce off your knee, which is what happened to Thornton.
Especially something coming that hot.
Yeah, there was a lot of power to that squib kick. It wasn't necessarily an onside kick. It was just a squibber. And here we go again. And there's the little squib kick, and it's fallen on, and the Polar Bears almost lost it at the 45. It was fallen on there. The Polar Bears come away with it.
And we've got good field position at the 45.
Taryn Boda recovered it at the 45, and Fairmont will go first and 10 from there with 3:04 to go in the third quarter, leading 28-21.
All right, let's see how we answer.
Dylan Hours in the backfield behind Whitehair. First down play. Hours gets the handoff. Hours coming this way. Goes left and back right. Gets to the 50 and ducks inside to about the 48-yard line. So he's going to get about 7 yards on the play.
Run down by number 68, Alex Blankenship.
Again, nice blocking up front. Hat on the hat. Dylan took a nice pop there at the end.
Blankenship gets the tackle. A 6'1", 255-pound sophomore, Dylan Hours, has just reached 100 yards rushing tonight. It's second and 3 from the Indy 48-yard line. Whitehair gives it to Hours. Hours off the right side, brought down at the line of scrimmage, the 49. Nice defensive play was made by Miles Greenway, 6'1", 205-pound junior. He had a big quarterback sack in this game earlier.
Brody should have pulled that. The end collapsed, or which would have been the outside backer collapsed.
Third down. And about 3 yards to go for the Polar Bears. The ball at the 49-yard line. They need to take it just inside the 46. White air back to pass. Sets up, looks short to the sidelines. Caught by Dinger along the sidelines, and he's knocked out of bounds at about the 41-yard line. It's a Polar Bear first down. It's an 8-yard pass.
Yeah, nice route by Dinger. Good ball by Brody.
Number one, Trey Bowers.
Pass protection was good.
First down, Fairmont Senior.
170 passing yards for Whitehair tonight. And the Polar Bears have a first down at the Independence 40. And we have a whistle at the line of scrimmage. And we're ready to go now. Ball marked at the 40 for the Polar Bears. First down and 10. A minute 45 on the stop clock. Polar Bears 28, Independence 21. There's Dylan Hours carrying the ball off the right side inside the 20, the 15. And no, he's down to the 20-yard line.
Yeah.
And it's a Polar Bear first down after a 19-yard gain.
Yeah, he was just one man from going distance on that.
So that was Tyler Linksweiler, who came over from his safety spot to make a touchdown-saving tackle on Dylan Hours.
Good blocking on that play by our O-line and on the perimeter with Dinger.
20-yard gain, first and 10 from the Independence 20. Damani Johnson back in the game for the Polar Bears. Dinger in motion. There's the little shovel pass to Dinger. Trying to get outside to the left. No place to go. Now he gets to the sidelines. Inside the 15. Cuts inside of the 10. He's at the 5. And he goes down inside the 5-yard line. Dinger ran out of options and then found one. And the Polar Bears get another first down. And it's going to be first and goal at the 4.
What an exciting play by number 10. You know, brought it all the way out to the edge. And he just waited for his blockers to catch up and brought it back up inside.
So at the 4-yard line, Hours comes up under center to run the team at quarterback. And on a quarterback sneak for Dylan Hours, he just fights his way down to the goal line. And he's going to be marked just short at the 1. So Hours gets 3 yards the hard way. He has 124 rushing yards tonight.
Can't get any closer than what we are now.
Officials calling time for some reason. We'll listen.
We need to play clock to 40 seconds after the play, not 25.
So the Polar Bears don't have to run another play. They could just take it to the fourth quarter and run the play then, as the game clock is ahead of the play clock.
Yes.
And that may be exactly what they do.
Oh yeah, because you want to suck time off the whole game clock itself.
And that's what Fairmont will do. They're leaving the huddle, heading to the sidelines, and it is after three quarters now from East West Stadium in Fairmont. It's the Fairmont Polar Bears 28, Independence 21 on Fun 93.1.
At the end of the third quarter, your score.
Hi, my name is Zach Frazier, and I'm from Fairmont, West Virginia. And when I'm back at home in Fairmont, you'll find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that Golden Boot Pride at Parmar. There are literally hundreds of Parmar stores in West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, and even more on the way. Download the Parmar app to save even more. And whether it's food, gas, groceries, or whatever, we have you covered at Parmar. West Virginia proud and ready to serve you.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
An injury at any age can be a game changer. But with walk-in clinics Monday through Saturday, the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute is ready to get you off the bench and back in the game. Marshall Sports Medicine Institute takes care of the herd. Let us take care of you.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
Here come the Polar Bears to the line of scrimmage. Second down, goal to go from the 1-yard line. And Hours comes up under center. He takes the snap. He takes it off the left side. He takes it down to the goal line and into the end zone. It's a polar bear touchdown. Dylan Hours scores on the one-yard run. It's his third touchdown of the night, and the Polar Bears lead it 34-21.
Yeah, that's a way to come back and answer Independence's score.
Number 44, Dan Peschel. His holder, number two, Logan Pantier.
Peschel comes in to attempt the extra point. He'll kick it from left to right. Bigelow to snap, Canfield to hold. The ball is up, and the kick is good. 11:56 to go, fourth quarter. Polar Bears 35, Independence 21 on Fun 93.1.
Here at the Cracker Barrel, homestyle food and great value go hand in hand with favorites like slow-simmered chicken and dumplings starting at $7.99. Or perfectly golden fluffy buttermilk pancakes with your own bottle of warm syrup. Come fill up on favorites without emptying your wallet. Cracker Barrel. Take care now.
The Polar Bears have retaken that two-touchdown lead now, and we're just underway in the fourth quarter. 11:56 to go, and Dinger will kick off for Fairmont.
I think both defenses stayed in the locker room, Jeff.
It has been an offensive second half for sure. Neither team has been able to stop the other. Here's Cannon Dinger's kickoff, and it's a squibber that runs inside the 10 and the 5, and Trey Bowers is thinking, oh, I hope that doesn't take a kick one way or the left, to the left or right, and not get into the end zone because he let it go up behind him, but is a touchback. And it'll be first and 10 for Independence at its own 20. We started this third quarter driving down and scoring, and the Polar Bears answered, and then Independence came right back down and scored, and the Polar Bears answered. So essentially we played one quarter and nobody gained an advantage now because it's still the same halftime, two-touchdown lead for Fairmont.
But with our defense allowing them to run the ball like they had this second half, it's definitely going to open up their passing game down the field.
Dove comes in motion, the quarterback keeping it off the right side, and he'll take it up to the 30-yard line for a first down, close to the 31, and Brody Whitehair in on the tackle for the Polar Bears. Holds his right elbow as he gets up after making that tackle. It's a 10-yard gain for the quarterback.
Yeah, this quarterback counter. They've ran it plenty of time tonight.
Nelson has run the ball more than anyone else. He is the quarterback. Lengsweiler is their leading rusher coming into this game, but he's only carried 9 times for 48 yards. And this time the handoff goes to Linksweiler, and he's tripped up by Bracero as he takes it over the 30 to about the 32-yard line, and it's going to bring up a second down and 8.
Yeah, nice job by our nose guard getting off the block and making enough contact to stop the ball carrier.
Linksweiler pounded his fist into the turf because he thought, oh, if I could have just gotten through that little ankle tackle, I had a big game. Second down and 8. From the Patriots 32. Two receivers split wide to the right side, two to the left, and the snap goes to the quarterback Nelson. He's trying to get outside to the left, and he'll get it out over the 35 to the 36, and then he's brought down there. Trying to bring up a third down and about 4 for the Patriots.
That's just straight, it's just going to be a straight quarterback ISO. Nice play by number 4, Brody Whitehair.
Whitehair's been in on some defensive plays tonight as well. Still get nervous with the quarterback on defense, but he's been playing enough in the playoffs now that I've kind of gotten accustomed to it. Third down and 4 with the ball at the Indy 36-yard line. Nelson calling the signals, trying to draw the Polar Bears off sides. They don't jump, and now there's a timeout Independence at the line of scrimmage. As the play clock was running down. Timeout Independence, 10:01 to go. Fourth quarter, Polar Bears 35, Indy 21 on Fun 93.1.
George, timeout Independence, first of the half.
National Bank, where you can purchase or refinance your home with the No Down Payment Champion Mortgage. No down payment, no private mortgage insurance, no kidding. Visit your local branch to get started today. City National Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. To learn more, log on to mortgage.bankatcity.com.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
Third, Princeton now leads Bridgeport 46-29. In the second, 12 minutes left in the half. Oregon 14, Oregon State 0.
Independence looking at a third down and four from the 36-yard line in its own territory. 10:01 to go in the game, and the Polar Bears lead by two touchdowns. Nelson in the backfield now. And he sends Bowers in motion, and there is the handoff up the middle to Linksweiler, and he rolls up close to the 40-yard line. Bowers makes the tackle, and let's see where they mark it. They say first down as they mark it just over the 40. So it'll be a four-yard gain for Linksweiler and an Independence first down.
Nice little play by Independence right there.
Clock turns inside, 9:48. We're in the fourth quarter. The Polar Bears have a 35-21 lead. Fairmont jumped out to a 14-0 lead. Then it was 14-7, and the Bears scored before the end of the first half to go up 21-7. Nelson on a first down and 10. Takes the snap, and he's going to run with it, and he is going to be hit at the line of scrimmage. Ball pops loose, and let's see who's got it.
Yeah, I think they might have us for a face mask.
They signal first down, or Polar Bear football. They call it a fumble, and Fairmont has the football just inside the 40-yard line.
Nice. Hey, first defensive stop of the second half.
And the ball is at the 39-yard line, so that will be a 2-yard loss for the quarterback. And the Polar Bears now have a big opportunity. 9:23 on the clock here in the third quarter, leading Independence 35-21, fighting for a trip to the state championship game. Play clock down to 5 seconds, and the Polar Bears know it, so they hustle the playoff. And here is the handoff to Hours off the right side. Dillon inside the 35. He's at the 30 and goes down at about the 27-yard line.
Nice. Good hard run.
Brought down by number 10, Dalton Williams.
Making the tackle was Dalton Williams for
Polar Bear. First down.
The Patriots, but a 12-yard gain for Hours.
Nice. Stayed on our doubles until we got to the, able to get to the second level for the lineman.
He's a tough guy to have to defend. First and 10 for the Polar Bears now at the Independence 27, and the Polar Bears jump off sides. The left side, pretty much all of them, Canfield, Dinger, and Navon Jones. So, 5-yard penalty, should take it back to about the 31, 32-yard line.
Dead ball, false start, offense number 10, 5-yard penalty, first down.
So it's coming back to the 31, where it's going to be first and 15 for the Polar Bears.
We got Gavin down here.
Fairmont has Michael wide right. And the pass goes to the far side. Dinger catches it at the 27-yard line. And he's fighting for extra yards. Gets to the 26. That'll be all. He'll only get about 5 yards on that pass play.
Got our 5 yards back. What I was saying is we got Gavin down here.
191 passing yards tonight for quarterback Whitehair. He's completed 17 of 22. I mean, very few of his passes have been thrown errantly. Obviously, he's only had 5 incompletions. Second down and 9. The ball at the 25-yard line. Brody checking the play clock. Gets the low snap, hands it off to Hours, trying to get outside to the left, hesitates, then gets down to the 20, the 15, and is run out of bounds on the far side of the field, inside the 15-yard line.
Picked up a big first down for us.
It will be set down inside the 15 at about the 12-yard line. A 13-yard gain for Dylan Hours. He has 152 rushing yards tonight.
You know, good job blocking the front row line and even on the perimeter by our receivers.
Now say it's at the 11 where they set it down, and the Polar Bears go first and 10 from the 11, 8:05 to go. You don't want any kind of a mistake here. Whitehair gives it to Hours, running wide to the right side. Dylan inside the 10, inside the 5. He's into the end zone. That's a Polar Bear touchdown. Dylan Hours takes it in from 11 yards out. And the Polar Bears lead it 41-21 with 7:58 to go.
A good play, double off the second level backer. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Good block by, you know, hey, big enough block by 10. Got bit Dylan in the end zone.
I feel like I'm right in the locker room again, listening to you going over the video of the game. Extra point by Peschel. And now flags down at the line of scrimmage.
Good ball. False start. Offense number 75. 5-yard penalty on time down.
Deshaun Floyd called for offsides at the line of scrimmage. Cam Peschel has just kind of been flying under the radar lately. He's now 61 of 65 in extra points for the Polar Bears this season. And he'll kick from left to right, 5 yards farther away. And Canfield will hold. The kick is up, and the kick is good. Timeout on the field, 7:58 to go. The score, Fairmont Senior 42, Independence 21 on Fun 93.1.
I'm Keith Powell, and going on right now is my Keith Says Yes Fest. I'm saying yes to lowering your payments, yes to your trade-in, regardless of condition, miles, even if you're still making payments. My Keith Says Yes credit approval process helps me say yes, you're approved. So if you want new Chevys, yes. New Fords, yes. Lifetime warranty, yes. Come see me, Keith Powell, at Yes Chevy in Hurricane and Yes Ford in Huntington.
Senior will be number 10, Cannon Dinger. Back for Independence, number 1, Trey Bowers. Number 26, Tyler Linkswiler.
The Polar Bears trying to get back to the state title game are in good position now, up 42-21 with 7:58 to go. And Cannon Dinger will kick off from left to right. Here is his kick, high end over end, and Bowers will get it back at his 7-yard line, spins and comes back this way, gets up to the 15, heads to the sidelines, gets to the 20, and is going to be hit along the sidelines and knocked out of bounds, short of the 30-yard line.
Knocked out of bounds by number 8, Damani Johnson.
You know, he made the first guy miss, number 4, pretty, you know, you got your nose guard running down there. And Bowers made him miss, and he made a nice play to get the sideline.
So Independence will have the football. Now they're going to say he stepped out of bounds at the 28-yard line. So the ball's at the 28, first down and 10 for the Patriots, down by 3 touchdowns, 7:49 to go. And Nelson is back to pass. Sets up off-balance throw downfield for Bowers, and the pass is incomplete now. I thought he might have been able to get interference on that.
Yeah, that looked more interference than in the first half.
It looked like Thornton maybe grabbed the receiver, but there was no call on that. So,
yeah, that one there. That one there should have been called. That one in the first half shouldn't have.
To our Independence fans who are listening, let me just explain, first of all, I've been broadcasting Polar Bear games for 30 years, so it's hard to be unbiased in these kinds of games. So, but I will tell you that one, we agree, probably should have been a flag. Second down and 10 now, coming up for the Patriots. The ball at the 28, and the handoff goes to Linksweiler. Linksweiler is grabbed by Michael, and he gets it up to about the 30, and that'll be all. He'll gain just 2 yards on the play.
You know, it was a good job by Hours of setting the edge right there. Nice job by both, but especially for Hours for setting the edge.
Third down and 8 yards to go now. The ball at the 30, and the Polar Bears holding a 42-21 lead over the Independence Patriots, who won the state title last season without even being threatened. Third down play, Nelson back to pass. Nelson launches it to the far sidelines, and the pass is incomplete, intended for Trey Bowers. Johnson depending on the play, and it's fourth down and eight coming up now for Independence.
Intended for number one, Trey Bowers. Covered by number eight, Damani Johnson.
Chance if anybody got to him.
Fourth down.
Putting situation.
Nice number eight.
And the quarterback, Nelson, lines up as a putter. Line of scrimmage is the 30. Takes lots of time again, but punts it straight up in the air.
Get away from it.
And it'll go out of bounds in Independence territory. Inside the 45. No, right at the 45-yard line. The Polar Bears get it with 6:47 to go, leading 42-21. The Independence team last year, I thought watching them play, could have given anybody in any division a good game. They were really a solid team, and nobody in Double-A could come close.
Yeah, the team they had last year, but, you know, I'm pretty sure they've lost, you know, they, look who they lost from last year's team. But, no, last year's Independence team was a finely tuned machine.
Handoff goes in the backfield, and there's just no room for Dylan Hours that time as he runs it to the right side. He's going to lose a couple of yards on the play before Dalton Williams brings him down. A two-yard loss for Hours, but
you know, right now we just need time to come. You know, time. We just need time to come off right now. He lost 2 yards. Lost 2 yards. But look, we're going to have almost a minute run off the clock here.
And usually Fairmont's pretty good in these situations with clock management and not snapping the ball too soon. Play clock shows 15 seconds, and White Air comes to the line of scrimmage. Just as I say that, they snap it with 12 left. And here's Whitehair scrambling around in the backfield. Now he takes it down to the 45, slides down. He'll be marked down just short of the 45-yard line, and it will bring up a third down play.
Yep, just keep, you know, Clocker is our friend right now. Just let it run.
Third down, Fairmont Senior.
We've scored enough to win the game. Just keep the clock running.
Following the game tonight, we will have our Elevate Physical Therapy player or players of the game mentioned. Wideouts to the left. And wideouts to the right. Empty backfield for White here on this third down and 10 play. Polar Bears lead 42-21, 5:17 to go. And Brody's back to pass. Has time. Now sends it over the middle. And Canfield is hit as he goes for the ball. And it's incomplete.
Yeah.
So, incomplete pass, and the Polar Bears will punt it away with 5:10 left. Yeah.
I know our fan, the Fairmont Senior fans are unhappy right now with that, but, you know, the worst thing is the clock stopped.
And Hours will be punting for the Polar Bears. Line of scrimmage is the 45.
Ooh.
And there's a fake, and the Polar Bears have it. And running with it for Fairmont Senior down inside the 20, the 15, the 10, the 5 is Boda. And he takes it down to about the 6-yard line. There is a flag on the play. Waiting for the call from the referee.
A little formation against the Kenyon team. 5 yards from the previous spot. Fourth down.
So 5-yard penalty, illegal formation. So many times that means you don't have enough guys on the line of scrimmage. But the Polar Bears have had that penalty twice tonight. This time it will erase a beautiful fake punt. Taryn Boda carrying the ball and all the way down inside the 20-yard line. But now Hours is back to punt again, and he may very well punt this time. Line of scrimmage is midfield at the 50. Dylan had a 66-yard punt here in the second half. High snap, brings it down. Has lots of time. He's thinking about what he's going to do now. He punts it away. And the Polar Bears have time to get their coverage team down there, but they didn't. And the ball goes into the end zone for the automatic touchback. With 4:40 to go, Independence will get the ball at its own 20-yard line, trailing the Polar Bears 42-21.
If Dinger could have just got her. But, you know, biggest,
ball under the end zone after the kick. Independence
biggest,
will take over
biggest thing is the clock is our friend. Line. You know, we've scored enough to win. We just need the time to run off.
4 minutes and 40 seconds on the clock. Now Independence has to be thinking, we got to put this ball in the air as they're trailing by three touchdowns. And they have it at their own 20-yard line. No, they don't. They give it to Linksweiler, and he carries it up the middle, and he'll get five before Hours has him, along with Logan Canfield. Five-yard gain. It'll be second down and five. Dylan a little slow in getting up. And Independence not in a big hurry either, as they come to the line of scrimmage now with a second and five at their own 25, and they trail 42-21. Nelson, the quarterback, passes to the far side right along the line of scrimmage, and the pass is caught at the 25-yard line, taken over the 30, up to about the 35.
Number 12's pass complete to number
13. It'll be a 10-yard pass. And a first down.
I believe they kept him in bounds, so this clock should start as soon as they spot it.
First down for Independence.
I don't know why that, you know, they're having issues with the play clock not being set to 40.
Now the clock is running, yep. And the play clock was set on that 10-yard pass play. And it's first down and 10 for Independence. And here is Nelson again, running with the football. And he gets up to the 40, the 45, the 50, and into Polar Bear territory. The ball comes out, but he's already down.
Nelson, the ball carrier. Tackle made by number 8, Johnson.
20-yard run for Nelson on that carry.
Oh, big hole up front.
And another Independence first down.
And the clock is running. That's good.
Down to 3:25, and the Polar Bears are up by 21 points. Three wideouts to the left side. The quarterback in the shotgun formation, and he's back to pass. He's sending one downfield, and the pass is intercepted. Dinger's got it again. Cannon Dinger, his second interception of the night, his 15th of his career, and the Polar Bears have the football with 3:07 to go.
Yeah, I mean, he had the protection. He just threw her short. He put too much air under.
So it's going to be first down for the Polar Bears, first and 10 in their own territory at the 10-yard line, leading 42-21. Independence has two timeouts left. And the Polar Bears are 3 minutes away from heading to the state championship again. White air in the pistol formation. Center Arbogast snaps in the ball. Hours gets the handoff. Dylan wide to the left side, dragged down by the arm at about the line of scrimmage. You can never assume he's going down.
No.
Until you actually see the play called dead, because there have been so many times I thought, okay, he's down, and then all of a sudden, there he goes. He'll get two, it'll be second down and 8 from the 12. So 163 rushing yards for Dylan Hours tonight, and he has scored 4 touchdowns. White air gives it to Chris Wilson, trying to get outside to the left. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, the 10, the 15, and grabbed by the helmet and thrown down at about the 19-yard line.
Yeah, it was a great run by Chris there, but want to stay in bounds, keep that clock running. We're down to 2:15.
He was able to get it within a yard of the first down marker, though, to the 19.
Be a first down for Fairmont Senior.
Now they say it is
a
first down. So Call it at the 20-yard line. First and 10, Polar Bears, 2:15 to go. And here is Wilson running wide to the left side. And Wilson takes it up over the 20, up to about the 23-yard line.
Good hard run.
Three-yard gain. And it's going to be second down and about 7 to go for the Polar Bears. Clock's down to a minute 54. Fairmont Senior leading Independence 42-21. And the Polar Bears are headed to another state title game. Will it be North Marion or will it be Weir? We'll find that out tomorrow night as those two teams play at Roy Michael Field. How about Bridgeport and Princeton? Princeton leads the Indians 47-35, fourth quarter. Victory formation for the Polar Bears now.
Best formation in football.
And Brody White here takes a knee with a minute 18 to go.
I want you to be safe as you're leaving East West Stadium tonight. Put your cell phones away. Watch the pedestrians and stop for people.
Brings up a third down.
If you are walking, make sure drivers can see you.
Third down and about 8 yards to go now. Independence is not stopping the clock. You admire them for not doing that because it would just prolong this game for no reason. They do have two timeouts left, but down by three touchdowns. Play clock at 16, game clock at 46. What that means is this will be the final play here at East West Stadium this season. White hair takes a knee.
Yep.
And that will be the final play of the game.
Going
the
back.
The Bears head from the sidelines to the center of the field to celebrate a return trip to the state championship game in Wheeling as Fairmont Senior has beaten the Independence Patriots, the final score tonight in the state semifinals. The Fairmont Senior Polar Bears 42. And the Independence Patriots 21. We'll have the wrap-up coming up next on Fun 93.1. Oh, I'm glad to hear that. Thank you. That's right. You got that other game. Yeah. All right. Good.